Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome into First Arena. The Elmira Mammoth are coming off their first win in franchise history on Wednesday night, and the Danbury Hattricks have yet to lose a game during regulation this season. They also come in on a five-game win streak. The 1-9-1 Elmira Mammoth take on the Danbury Hattricks, who come in 10-0-1. I'm Jake Johnson. Alongside me is Michael Cosentino. And Mike, first win in the history books. They now look to build on that tonight against the first-place Hattricks.
Absolutely. This is a team that's played very well this season. Has a kind of a similar group to the group they've had over the past couple of years in the FPHL. A lot of big returners, you know, Kuznetsov and Johnny Ruiz, McDonald, guys like that who have been on the team. But I think the Mammoth really showed something on Wednesday night that they can win games when they play as a unit and when they play together. So hopefully we'll see that same Mammoth team here tonight.
That same Mammoth team that is coming off a 8-2 victory over the Delaware Thunder, a team that they're now tied for last in the standings. The Mammoth own the fourth place spot due to beating the Delaware Thunder that night. Goals scored by Parker Moskow, who had a hat trick. Tate Leeson with two goals. Tyler Pekarski with his first ever pro goal. Stavros Soyas with a goal. And Nuke Gulo with a goal. So, you know, like, you see those same group of guys, Parker Moskow, Tate Leeson getting involved, but some new guys. Stavros Soyas scores a goal. Nick Gulo scores a goal. So it wasn't the Yanni Lyriakos and Parker Moskow that we saw before. A lot of different guys got in the scoring column.
Absolutely, and that's all part of coming together more as a team is when you start getting contributions from your second line guys, from your third line guys. Obviously, it's great when the big names up front on the first line can score, but when you start getting contributions from those depth players, that's really when your team starts to gel and come together and win some games.
Now, we look at this Danbury Hattricks team, and they had a 6-2 victory over the Binghamton Black Bears, and they're led by that same group of guys, Dustin Jussot, Dmitry Kuznetsov, Luke Richards, the same guys that we talked about the last time these two teams played, Mike.
Yeah, Dustin Jussot, 23 points, 7 games played, averaging 3.3 points per game. I believe that's the highest in the FPHL, and to be honest, that's the highest points per game percentage I've ever seen in the FPHL. He's obviously doing really well, and yeah, they have a lot of other guys that can put the puck in the net. So, once again, this is a Mammoth team coming off a big win Wednesday, a lot of positive momentum, but this is also a Danbury team that won Wednesday as well against Binghamton and is feeling really good about their game.
Now, let's talk about the last two times that these teams matched up. That was in the Danbury Ice Arena. The first game of the weekend, it was an 8-4 Danbury victory. But at the end of the second period, Mike, it was a 5-4 game in favor of the Hattricks. A game that was close, a game that the Mammoth trailed 4-0, were able to work their way back into it. So a one-goal game heading to the intermission.
Yeah, it was a close matchup that game. Both games were close in the beginning, obviously the second one being close for a little bit more. But I think the Mammoth are a much improved team since that weekend. You could make the case that Danbury's gotten a little bit better in certain areas as well. But a couple big names out of the lineup tonight. I think Johnny Ruiz being out of the lineup tonight for Danbury is the most important factor for the Mammoth because he's the captain. He's the guy that puts up a lot of points. And, you know, I'm not sure exactly why he's not playing. But him being out of the lineup and this Mammoth team being so much better, I think this is a really big opportunity for Elmira.
And you talked about that second game of the weekend, Saturday night. End of the first period, the game was tied at 1. End of the second period, it was only a 2-1 game. So another game where the Mammoth were right in it. A goal going their way, they were able to tie the game up or take the lead if it was during that second period of time. So a game that they were in, and they've done a good job of hanging around with teams, but so far this season it seems like the third period has really got away from them.
Yes, it has. And for younger teams, typically that'll be the most difficult part is finishing off a game like that. Wednesday, I think, was a big game for the Mammoth because they were able to get out to that early lead. Now, obviously, if you could have it your way, you'd always want to get out to an early lead in every game that you play. That's just not realistic. Tonight, I think the recipe for the Mammoth, the recipe for success, is going to be get out, play good defensive hockey early. If you can get a couple goals, great, but you have to avoid Danbury having that big first period. If they get a couple early, it's going to be a very, very difficult game to come back from.
How much momentum do you think a win on Wednesday night builds for this team this weekend, a game against the first play Hattricks, the third place Watertown Wolves as the Mammoth head there Saturday night? How much momentum does a win build, finally getting the way we called the last time, the monkey off your back?
It's enormous, Jacob. You know, the guys in the locker room, they really wanted that first win in franchise history, and it's not just any first win. I mean, obviously the Mammoth were winless going into Wednesday's game, but it wasn't just winless this season. It was the first win in franchise history, which is a little bit extra pressure on you if you're a player. And I think now that that monkey's off the team's back, you can really start to see how this team is going to gel long term.
Yeah, you talk about the gelling of this team. A little different look. It seems like for the Elmira Mammoth, they're kind of trying to stick with the same group. Dakota Seaman inserted into the lineup. And Troy Button, we wish him the best, headed to Birmingham on loan for the SPHL. But those are the only two changes in this lineup tonight for the Elmira Mammoth.
Yeah, obviously, congratulations to Troy on the call-up opportunity, and I think he'll do really well there. Besides that, like you said, just one tweak on the forward end of things. But for the most part, you know, Coach Damaris keeping the lines the same, keeping the D pairings the same. Thomas Proudlock getting another start in net, played very, very well on Wednesday. So, you know, it's kind of the thing right now. If it's not broke, don't fix it.
Yeah, and you talk about Thomas Proudlock getting the start. Now moves his record a little bit better here on the season. He's 1-2 on the year, a 4.85 goals against average, an .877 save percentage, and has 142 saves. And backing him up tonight is the new addition to the Elmira Mammoth team in Richard Shipman. He was recently brought over from Port Huron, now playing for the Mammoth. He gets his chance to back up Thomas Proudlock tonight.
Yeah, Richard Shipman is a very good goalie. He's a goalie that was in the league last year, did a really good job for Port Huron, and he's going to be a good addition to the team. And I think the Mammoth have three good goaltenders in Proudlock, Shipman, and White. I think any one of those guys can get in and win games for you. And I think, you know, Shipman's definitely excited to be in there tonight wearing a Mammoth jersey for the first time.
And it's a little interesting. We look on the other side of things, the starting netminder for the Hattricks. It's going to be Parker Butler, a guy that we didn't see in the last matchup. The Friday night start went to Brian Wilson, and the Saturday night start went to Frankie McClendon. So Parker Butler, he's now getting his chance. Interesting to see them shake it up, especially after the Mammoth come off a win. You want to make another statement?
Yeah, that surprised me, to be completely honest. Parker Butler, obviously a very capable goalie, played NCAA hockey. It was at Elmira College his freshman year, and then he transferred to UMass Dartmouth. So was in the NCAA for 4 years, had some really good numbers. So obviously he's a capable goalie. Did surprise me lineup-wise to see Danbury not going with Wilson or McClendon, but I think this is the first start that Butler's getting this year, and it's definitely going to be a good test against a Mammoth team with a lot of momentum.
Under 8 minutes until puck drop here at First Arena. We'll be right back. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to give our players to watch in this one, as well as our score predictions. Don't go anywhere. You're listening to the Elmira Mammoth YouTube and Elmira Mammoth Mixer. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to First Arena here in Elmira, New York. The Elmira Mammoth taking on the Danbury Hattricks as myself, Jake Johnson, and Michael Cosentino are going to get to our players to watch and our score prediction for this one. But I do want to make a note. Cosentino was talking about before in the warm-ups, Johnny Ruiz is not dressed tonight. He is standing on the bench. He is the player assistant coach for the Danbury Hattricks. So we see him right now. He's across on the Danbury Hattricks bench with head coach Billy McCreary. Very interesting there, Cos. You know, not playing your player assistant coach. Obviously, it's a long season, so a chance to rest against a team that struggled this year.
I understand the decision. You know, they have a game tomorrow. They have the game tonight, and they had a game Wednesday. So 3 games, 4 days. Obviously, that's a tough schedule. At the same time, Johnny Ruiz is your leader, right? He's your captain. He's your guy. Excuse me. He's your guy that puts up big points. So I'm a little shocked to see him not in the lineup tonight. He could be battling an injury or something. Obviously, Danbury feels like they're the type of team that can win without him in the lineup. So I guess we'll see how it goes.
Yes. Let's get to our players to watch, Cos, and I'll let you start for the Danbury Hattricks. Who's your player to watch tonight?
For the Danbury Hattricks tonight, my player to watch is number 77, Dmitry Kuznetsov. Played in the league last year for Danbury, had a bunch of points, doing really well this year with a call-up opportunity to the SPHL so far. He's the type of guy that looks, you know, kind of stays quiet out there, but he skates around really well, and he can score goals, so definitely watch for him to have a breakout game here tonight.
Kuznetsov scored twice the other night against the Binghamton Black Bears. And Dustin Jusseau had one as well. So the two guys that you always look for in this Hattricks lineup. I'm going to go with number 81, Tristan Mock. Now, the last time we played in the Danbury Ice Arena, Mock just seemed like he was flying by everybody. You know, he uses his speed. He works around the outside. And he's pretty quick with the puck. 3 goals and 2 assists this year. He's just played in 9 games. Played for Westfield State University last year. So before that, I think Tristan Mock's just a player to look out for. He's going to use his speed to his advantage. Now, for the Elmira, Mike, who do you got?
For the Elmira Mammoth tonight, my player to watch is Mo Levesque, number 94. Mo Levesque is one of the most veteran players in this league. He's a high-skilled power forward, and he hasn't been on the stat sheet all as much as he would probably like this season. He usually puts up a lot, you know, more in the goal department, and I think tonight you're going to see him have a breakout game in the goal department.
Now, I'm going to go with the player assistant for the Elmira Mammoth in Parker Moskal. Now, this is not because he's scoring all the goals for the team, but in theory, it almost is because of that. Now, the last time they played this Danbury team, in the 4-1 loss, the lone goal was scored by Parker Moskal. In the 8-4 loss, he had a hat trick. Now, Wednesday night, he had a hat trick. So, not only has he played well against Danbury, but the last few games, he has continuously been on fire. So, he's someone that, you know, he's always going to make a difference. But it just seemed like in those games against Danbury, he was all over the place and really trying to will his team to a victory.
It's a safe pick, Jacob, for sure.
And now let's get to our, as we run through the starting lineup here at First Arena with the lights off, our score predictions. Mike, you start.
My score prediction for tonight's game is a win for the Elmira Mammoth, coming at the score of 4-3. I think it's going to be a close game. I think it's going to be a physical game, but I do think Elmira will ride that Wednesday momentum into their second win in franchise history tonight.
I'm actually going to agree with you. I think that the Elmira Mammoth are going to get it done as well. That momentum, that first win in franchise history, I think it builds this team to something that we've expected them to be the last couple weeks. And now to get that one win, I think it's going to build upon something, especially without Johnny Ruiz playing. I think that's huge for this Mammoth team. They're rolling back the exact same lineup, Danbury missing their top one or two players for their team. I really like the Elmira Mammoth in this one. I'm going to go with a 4-2 victory, empty netter, near the end of it to seal the deal.
I like both of those results, Jacob. Let's see how it goes.
We're going to take a quick break as the national anthem is going to get going here at First Arena. Don't go anywhere. Puck drop in just a few moments.
Can you see by the dawn's early light?
Alexis Bradford with the national anthem here at First Arena. She'll be performing live later in Fandemonium. Mike, if you're interested in maybe jamming out a little later on with me after the Mammoth win.
I am very interested in jamming out.
Okay.
Can't pass up good music, Jacob.
You can't. You raise a good point. As we get ready to go here, head coach Glenn Tamaris on the bench for the Mammoth and for the Danbury Hattricks, head coach Billy McCreary.
Billy McCreary not wearing his fedora tonight.
I noticed that today when I was bringing in paperwork. I didn't make a comment to him, but I was thinking something looks a little off in here.
Something is off. He must have forgotten it.
He had to, but he does have his hockey cap on. I believe it's a Carhartt, maybe a Bauer. And the one thing actually we didn't talk about, Mike, look at those jerseys on the ice right now. The Mammoth rocking their orange alternate jerseys for the first time this season. We've seen them in pictures, but now they're live on First Arena Ice as we have puck drop.
They definitely pop.
Right off the rip, it's the Mammoth in the neutral zone as Soyuz dumps it in. Gonzalez, the first one of that puck. Gonzalez plays it up for Giseau. Giseau working by now. He plays a drop pass. Shot on net. Proud luck with an easy save.
You'll see Justin Giseau do that pretty often throughout the game, what he just did there. He'll come into the zone over the blue line, the offensive zone, and he'll kind of pull up and go left or right and wait for somebody to come and support and give that pass. That's just a really good veteran style of hockey by him.
Campbell now stops after winning the draw behind Proudlock. Levac looked to move by. Now he goes to him on the far side. Well, Levac working his way up as he chips it in. Hops right out in front. Yanni Liriakos chases. Jared Yao, the first one of that puck, able to give it off for Evan Lugo. Lugo into the neutral zone. Finds John McDonald. McDonald plays back for Kuznetsov. Now coming the other way as Levac slips down.
Levac just lost his edge there. If he didn't lose his edge, it probably would have been a 3-on-1 for Elmira.
Now working their way up, it's Luke Richards. He loses the puck, but able to get it back in and just plays into the offensive zone. Proudlock comes in. Gets a touch on the pucks, and it's played over for Yanni Liriakos. Liriakos into the near side corner, just flips it up into the air as it goes into the defensive end for Danbury as they have to go pick up. Now working their way through, it's Brendan Sheehan. He's sent to the ground by Jakub Wolf. Shot on that one, deflected off Anderson, right to the stick of Thomas Proudlock. He'll cover up for a defensive zone draw.
Could have been a dangerous play there. I think that shot was just to be a cross-corner dumping. Hit off, I think Dalton Anderson just went right on net. Nice awareness there by Pravla.
And, Mike, we see Jakub Wolf starting again. And I talked with Coach Glenn Tamaris about that. He said he had 6 blocked shots the other night. That's why he's getting this, because an offensive team like Danbury, his body is going to be needed to block some more shots tonight.
Absolutely. He's going to be needed very much so.
Maritea wins a draw, plays it to the far side for Isaiah Crawford. Comes in the neutral zone, picked up now by Gibbs. Cody Gibbs plays it all the way through. Right at the half wall. Crawford tried to clear it. It's kept in, though, by Gonzalez, who hands off for Mock. Mockberg now the far side, drop pass for Gonzalez. Slap shot winding up was Gibbs. That one blocked by Wolf. Now battle behind for Maritea. He plays into the far side. Bounces off the sidewall. Play to the point, Gonzalez shoots on. That one's blocked as well, doesn't reach Proudlock. Maritea held up. Kicks over for Danilek. Danilek now working through the defensive end and plays it into the neutral zone and hits Gibbs right at center ice. Gibbs just plays it in. Both teams going to get changes.
Couple nice blocks there for Elmira by Wolf and Maritea so far, not letting those pucks get to Proudlock.
Now as it comes down, it's Stavros Soilis. Soilis tried a centering pass for Tate Leeson. That one was blocked. Played in a backhand deep behind the cage. Kuznetsov. His pass blocked by Moscow, picked up by O'Connor in the neutral zone, and he tried to send it through, but Giseau right there. Giseau works by Soyuz, plays back for Abdellah. Abdellah deeks a little as he enters the offensive zone. Shot on Proudlock, he sticks it into the corner. Tyler Pikarski, who scored his first ever pro goal Wednesday night against the Thunder. Tried to send a pass into the neutral zone. That one's picked off. Now Giseau. Giseau down his far side. He shoots. Saved by Proudlock. Still loose out in front. Cleared by Pikarski. Now it's Leeson the other way. Leeson with 3 hat tricks on him. Leaves for Moskal. Moskal walks in. Dangles by. Sent out in front. Nobody home. Now it's Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov face guarded by Nick Gulo. He takes a shot on that one, sticked by Proudlock. It's kept in by Richards. Richards sends it down. Proudlock puts it on a stick, and he'll cover up for the draw.
Good amount of action here for Proudlock. Six saves for him already in this first period, not even 5 minutes in. No shots against on Butler. And I have to say, if you're the Mammoth, you have to be looking for a way to get to Butler early, being his first professional start.
It's going to be an offensive zone draw here for the Hattricks. 16:33 to play. Six shots already for the Hattricks. None for the Mammoth. Campbell spins away, loses the puck off his stick. It's played to the blue line. Dumped right in. Proudlock able to cover up. It took a weird bounce as it went towards the side of the cage. He was able to cover up another draw and another shot on goal. Just about 3.5 minutes gone by here in the first period. Face off won by the Hattricks again. Levac the first one to a shot that went wide. Now Lyriakos in the neutral zone. Goes for Gulo. Picked off by Levac. It was a cross-ice pass. Levac into the offensive zone. Drop pass. Slap shot. That one saved. Still loose out in front. Now it comes to the corner. Played up. And worked through. Picked up by Becker. Becker avoids a hit. That one's picked off by Jared Yao. Yao goes up for Mach. Mach retreats, and we're going to get a whistle. I believe it'll be an icing call on the Hattricks.
It's actually a nice save there by Parker Butler's first professional save. But that was a pretty good drop pass there by Mo Levac. Let Campbell walk in and take a slap shot, and he actually had to be alert and make a pretty quick blocker save.
Dalton Anderson takes the draw, and we're going to get a whistle. That'll bring the faceoff back. To the corner. It's worked up by the newest member of the Hattricks, Michael Marchessault. Marchessault picked up from the Binghamton Black Bears after he was released. Goes for Danilik in the defensive end. Plays up for Wolf. Wolf able to kick it in the neutral zone, but the first one to it is Mike Lopez. And it looks like we'll get another icing call. It'll be an offensive zone draw for the Mammoth.
Coach Tamaris using this icing by Danbury to get his hottest offensive line out there of Leeson, Soilis, and Moskal. As we said, they combined for six goals last game.
It's going to be a far side offensive zone drop. Hattricks win that one, and Tristan Mach. Abdella goes over for another new member of the Hattricks, Connor Lind. Mach skates by Pekarski, but Proudlock comes out, plays to the far side. First one to it's Lopez. Battle with O'Connor. Lopez comes away with a centering pass right out in front. It's played in the corner by Stavros Soilis.
Great back check there by Soilis to get to the front of the net and not allow a tapping goal.
Race for the puck. Abdel beats Leeson. It'll bring an offensive zone faceoff here for Danbury.
You know, those are the type of plays. They're not the most flashy plays, but they are definitely the most valuable plays. Justin Gesso, leading goal scorer in the FPHL, going for a backdoor tap, and Stavros Soilis, who's been playing very well, gets back and doesn't allow him to do that.
Lugo taking the draw against Parker Moskal. It's held right at the blue line. Now Stavros Soilis in a foot race. Him and Leeson combined. 2-on-1 the other way. It's Tate Leeson. Now he spins to the faceoff dot and works by. Leeson goes to the far side pass for Moskal. Moskal has that one chipped off his stick. Now 3-on-2 the other way for the Hattricks. It's Dustin Gesso. He has Kuznetsov in the middle. Good job by Becker to poke it off his stick. Now he goes down. Now it's Moskal the other direction. Moskal works by Evan Lugo. Pass over for Becker. Becker now for Leeson. Leeson just dumps it into the corner. Centering pass, that one Leeson couldn't handle. Now he drops it back for Gulo. Gulo walks and shoots, saved by Butler. Just so, into the neutral zone, Kuznetsov. Stops at the red line. Absorbs a hit there from Nick Gulo, who goes down. So works his way back in the defensive end. And I believe we'll get a whistle here. 14:06 to play. 7 shots for the Hattricks, 2 for the Mammoth.
Too many men on Elmira here.
You know what I find fascinating, Mike? When they call a penalty, sometimes I don't think they tell the teams who's the penalty on, because the penalty box opened both of them. See, that's what I mean. A penalty's going on the Danbury Hattricks, and head to the box is Daniel Amesbury, but they opened both of them.
They pump faked us. They opened the Elmira door.
Well, that's going to be a power play here. They'll off as a Kevin Flynn power play for the Elmira Mammoth. We've seen them succeed very well on this power play. 3-for-4 the other night on the power play, 75%, and they've continued to play well on it. So Moscow pass over for the Iraquis on the far side. He shoots, saved by Butler. Rebound chance, that one's sent wide. Now Levac, drop pass for Moscow. Moscow, Liriakos slap shot, he didn't get all of it. Lula for Liriakos. Liriakos cross ice for Levac. Levac picks it up along the half-board, shot by Moscow, to goal!
No, it's going to be waved off, high stick by Soilus.
Immediately waved off, they're going to call a high stick on Stavros Soilus. And it seemed like they both knew it.
It was a high stick, for sure. Soilus isn't arguing much, he knows it. Fans don't like it here in Elmira, but definitely above the crossbar.
20 seconds into it, though. And Mike, the good thing is they're taking shots on net. They're getting quick shots on net. They've had 2 or 3 already on this power play just 20 seconds in.
Yeah, so far that power play looked really good. Had a couple shots. Butler's had to make a couple tough saves here. So.
So now they're going to have a conversation about this. And Mike, I feel like we both agree that it was a high stick. They can't really look at it. But, you know, they just showed the replay there, and it does look like a high stick.
Definitely. Whenever the stick blade or the middle of the stick is above the shoulders of the player who has it, typically that's a good way of determining if you don't have the angle whether it's above the crossbar or not. And you can also tell by the player's reaction, right? Like Soilus, goal goes in, he celebrates. We'll see it on the replay here.
And then,
he didn't really argue it much. I think he knew that one wasn't going to count.
Good call there by the official, though. Tough call to make, especially, you know, the Boo Birds are going to start. You're at a home arena, and you take away a goal from the home team. So a good call there, though, from the official.
Absolutely. You know, being a referee is a tough job. And, you know, it's tough to make those calls, but definitely the right one there.
Back to the Flynn power play after the media timeout here. 13:42 to play in the first period. Mammoth with 1:34 left on their power play. Back in the neutral zone, goes up for Gulo. Gulo tries to whack it out of the air. Comes to Gonzalez, who clears it all the way down. Proudlock has to come out of his net to play it. Pass through for Moskal, and nobody was headed that direction, and he'll be touched up for an icing call.
Still plenty of time left on this power play. 1:15. And it feels like they've been on the power play for longer because they've already gotten a couple really good grade A chances.
And then the media timeout just extends things.
And then the door was wrong. And
the door was all
wrong.
You
know, just a lot going on.
Offensive zone faceoff here coming for the Hattricks. That one won by Soilus and the Mammoth. Plays it back for Moskal. Moskal works through center ice, goes for Liriakos. Liriakos cross ice pass for Gulo. Gulo plays it off the boards. And that one just picked up immediately by Cody Gibbs. Proudlock comes out and leaves it for Moskal. Moskal drops it back for Liriakos. Liriakos through the defense zone, pass now for Crawford. Excuse me, that's Nathan Campbell on the ice, the defenseman. Works down the near side, pass for Liriakos. Liriakos back out of the blue line for Moskal. 40 seconds remaining here on the power play. Moskal looked for a cross-ice pass, still loose out in front. Now Soilus gets to it along the sideboards. Goes for Liriakos. Liriakos now over for Campbell. Campbell down low for Moskal on the far side. Pass for Liriakos, too far from him, and it's going to clear the zone. Campbell has to skate back to get it. Change coming now. It's Liriakos in the offensive zone. Pass back from Moskal, goes back and forth with him. Another centering pass try. It's picked up by Campbell at the blue line. 15 seconds. Now right in the slot. Anderson, he shoots. That one saved. Now Kuznetsov looking for a breakaway. He has Campbell on him. Shot saved by Proudlock. Big save. They were looking for a shorthanded goal for the Hattricks, and that's going to clear out the power play. Mammoth 0-for-1.
Pretty good penalty kill by Danbury there. They adjusted it about halfway through, and they made some really nice adjustments to keep the Mammoth from getting any more grade A's.
as Tim O'Connor goes down right in the slot, and it's picked up by Kuznetsov, who just dumps it in. No hands raised there. 11:50 to play here in the first period. Jared Yao goes off the boards. Up for Anderson. Anderson passed for Crawford. Now comes back to Anderson. Anderson just backhands it in. Comes into the neutral zone. Piekarski, the first one to that puck. Yao goes for McDonald. McDonald off his skate down into the near side corner. Amesbury hit hard there by Tim O'Connor. And it looks like we'll get a whistle.
They're not calling O'Connor, are they? Oh, my God, that's a horrible call. That's an awful call. Oh, no, sir, you missed that one.
So O'Connor heads to the box now for 2 minutes.
Head contact. That's a clean hit, Jacob. Oh, boy.
Brings us a Vincenzo's Pizzeria penalty kill here at first arena, the first one of the game. Mammoth already 0-1 on the power play. Hattricks are going to be 1-1 on the power play.
Yeah, that's just that's a missed call by the official there. It was a shoulder check right to the chest of Amesbury. I really don't get that one.
Kuznetsov works down low for Lugo. Lugo cross ice for Giseau. At the point, Giao quarterbacking. He throws a shot on that one off the post. Kuznetsov now for Yao. Yao down low for Giseau on the far side. 1:40 remaining on the power play. Lugo for Giseau. Giseau cross ice pass for Kuznetsov. He shoots. That one goes up and over off the glass. Now for Piekarski. Piekarski gets to it. Has it on his backhand. Able to clear it all the way down. Big, big clear there as the Mammoth able to get a change.
Nice kill by the Mammoth so far. Not letting a very struggling Danbury Hattricks power play get anything going.
A couple new guys now coming on for the Hattricks. Off their bench, it's Dijon. He works by Leeson into the offense zone, goes to the far side. Now he works down low, scoots by Maritea, and now he's held up along the backboards. Maritea, first one to it, goes for Campbell. Campbell, hassled by two Hattricks, able to get it to the blue line, but Gonzalez keeps it in. It's dropped down low for Lugo, under a minute remaining on the power play. Comes out for Leeson. Leeson plays it all the way down into the near side corner. Another big clear for the Mammoth.
Danbury power play just operating at 12% this season. That is the lowest power play percentage in the FPHL, despite them being in first place.
Pass across into the neutral zone. That one, Sheehan able to dump right in. Just 30 seconds remaining here on the power play. Proudlock comes in, wraps it around the boards, but that one's kept at the point by Sheehan. Sheehan over for Gonzalez. Gonzalez has that one whacked off his stick by Moskow. It's Leeson with a breakaway. Here comes Tate Leeson. Leeson moves by, tries to go 5-0, saved by Butler.
Great stop there by Butler. I mean, Leeson couldn't have perfected that move anymore, but Butler just stayed with him the whole way.
7 seconds remaining here on the power play for the Hattricks as Gonzalez walks in. Gonzalez throws on net. That one saved by Proudlock. Rebound chance. He was able to get a stick on it. O'Connor comes out of the box now. Successful penalty kill for the Elmira Mammoth. Out to the blue line for Gonzalez. He throws a harmless shot on that one. Loose out in front. Danock able to get to it. Leeson looks up for Moskow and bat out of the air by Gonzalez. That's a huge play. Moskow had clear, wide open ice in front of him.
It's a great penalty kill there by the Mammoth. Some good saves by Thomas Proudlock, too.
Official slips down here on the near side right in front of the penalty box. It's Tristan Mox. Skates back in the defensive end. Hands off for Yao. 8:45 to play here in the first period. Lopez able to shovel it into the offensive zone, getting a stick on it. Michael Marchand avoids a hit from Piekarski. Both guys go sliding down. Shot out in front. It's picked up there by Marchand. He takes a shot on. Off the pad of Proudlock, played in the far side corner. Now it comes back for Mock. Mock looked to center right there, but it comes out to the point. Some pushing and shoving between the two. And Cody Gibbs and Nick Gulo. Huge size advantage over there. Gulo looking to tussle with Cody Gibbs.
Didn't see how that one started, but yeah, that's definitely a lopsided matchup. Gulo has the heart, though, man. He will go toe-to-toe with anybody, one of the toughest, most energetic and, strong character guys I've ever played with.
Nick Gulo, just his second game for the Elmira Mammoth. He was able to net his first goal of the season on Wednesday night. He had 2 assists to go along with that, so a 3-point night for the newest member of the Mammoth now. He's going to head to the box for 2 minutes as well. as Cody Gibbs heads to the box for 2 minutes. So we're going to see some 4-on-4 hockey.
Yes, 4-on-4 hockey opens the ice up a little bit. One less forward out there typically allows for a little bit more creativity. So let's see how it goes.
Oskal on with Becker, Leeson, and Campbell. It's Kuznetsov towing the blue line as he passes it down low for Yao. Yao takes a short side to Sot. That one doesn't reach Proudlock.
Got to watch out for Dustin Jussieu here, number 22 in the open ice.
Cross pass for Yao. He shoots that one, saved by Proudlock. Kept in, though, by Kuznetsov. Goes over for Jussieu. Another shot on that one by McDonald, up and over off the glass. Now the Mammoth able to pick up. It's Tate Leeson through the neutral zone. Looks to do it all himself. Holds it on his stick, works behind Butler. Look for a wraparound now. Moskal shoots and saved.
Huge save by Butler there. Moskal had pretty much a wide open net, and somehow Butler got across.
Kuznetsov avoids a hit from Maritea, but forgets the puck in the neutral zone. Picked up by Moskal, goes over for Becker. Becker has that one hop off his stick. Jussieu takes over. Minute 05 remaining on the 4-on-4, just 7:24 remaining here in the period. Jussieu goes off the wall. Picked up by Maritea. He's unable to play it, just too far from his tape. And it goes up for Lugo. Lugo tried to pass through. Anderson got a skate on it. Comes back for Wolf in the defensive end. Jakub Wolf goes for Maritea. Maritea goes D to D with Daniluk. Daniluk leaves it back for Maritea. Now the Mammoths start a group. They work through the neutral zone. Maritea with speed goes for Wolf. Wolf walks in. He shoots that one, saved by Butler. Danilock and Wolf battling back behind the boards with Xavier Abdel and Brennan Sheehan. Wolf comes away with it. Pass in the neutral zone. Anderson and Connor just about collide, but O'Connor just going to dump it in the far side corner. Mammoth get two new forwards. Just 12 seconds remaining on the 4-on-4. Gibbs and Gulo ready out of the box. The pass is just chipped in by Lugo. Played in the near side corner. First one of that puck's Pekarski. Both guys come out of the box. Back to 5-on-5 hockey here at First Arena. 6:18 to play in the first period. Yanni Liriakos, he throws a harmless shot on. Butler makes a save, drops it to his feet, and he'll cover up. Mammoth get an offensive zone faceoff. 6:09 to play here in the period, and Kaz, first 14 or so minutes, it seems back and forth. Both teams having very good opportunities. Danbury, a couple good ones. Mammoth with a couple good ones, and to note, both had a really good shorthanded chance.
Yes, absolutely. I think the Elmira Mammoth have had actually the better chances so far. A couple shots right in the slot, and Butler, you know, he's only had 7 shots, but he's had to make 7 pretty difficult saves. Proudlock's been fantastic, too. He's had to make some beauties as well, but I think we're doing a pretty good job of keeping the pucks to the outside. Proudlock's a good enough goalie where if we keep guys to the outside, he will stop those shots.
As we welcome Landon Marsh here into First Arena, as we mentioned on the Wednesday night broadcast, and as you can see on the video feed on YouTube, Landon Marsh's jersey hung up in between both benches. Landon's fighting Hodgkin's lymphoma. Hodgkin's lymphoma here in Elmira. He's a member of the EC Ice Wings, and we're happy to have him in the building here tonight. So obviously we're thinking about him, happy that he's able to come out for an Elmira Mammoth game, and we're thinking and praying for him and his family as he goes through this tough time. Welcome back to First Arena here. Obviously a touching tribute there for Landon Marsh. Happy to see him in the building at First Arena tonight.
Absolutely.
So back to 5-on-5 hockey, just 6:09 to play as the Mammoth win that offensive zone draw. Comes to Becker, he throws a shot on that one, sticked away by Butler in the far side corner. Works its way into the neutral zone. Campbell just plays it in. Levac looking to skate on, back by the net. He creates a turnover. Look for a cross ice pass there, but nobody home. Gulo was not ready for it. Liriakos takes a shot, that one sent wide. Levac keeps it in, plays down low for Gulo. Gulo goes out to the point for Campbell. Campbell goes D to D with Becker on the far side. Becker, he takes a shot on that one, blocked by McDonald, comes to the feet of Yao. kept to the point by Becker, and now Gulo takes some hits from Yao. And we got a scuffle in the corner. Looks like all the members on the ice getting into it here. Some pushing and shoving. Becker being held up there as everyone on the ice, as Levac now has a body on Zach Papillion. Now guys are being taken down to the far side corner. Mentioned things got aggressive with these two teams at the Danbury Ice Arena. Gulo without his helmet. There's going to be a lot to sort out here. And Zachary Papillion immediately heads to the penalty box.
Zach Papillion, typically not a guy who gets mixed up too much. He's a guy I played junior hockey with, but definitely see him getting emotional here.
Now it looks like both teams heading to their respective benches. Some more words drawn between Lyriakos and Luke Richards. Jared Yao now entering the box. Mo Levac missing a glove. Nick Gulo missing his helmet. And Mike, it looks like, you know, the Mammoth just with one in the box. Danbury has two. This possibly could be a Flynn power play for the Elmira Mammoth.
I think Mo Levac's getting sent into the box, yep.
They got to stop playing these games with the doors.
No, they love it. It's their favorite thing to do. I knew Levac was getting a penalty by the ref was pointing at him, but not really sure how he got one. I guess they're going to probably maybe for third man in or something. I'm not sure, but this should even up after everything's said and done.
Parker Moskal having a conversation with the official on the near side here. Kyle Gonzalez there as well. So just 5:34 to play here in the first period as we get ready to sort things out. Interesting to note, Daniel Amesbury sitting right at center ice, a guy that was not involved in that play, but we know him as an aggressor. This is his first game back from an 8-game suspension after a hit against the Binghamton Black Bears. On Gavin Yates, so this is his first game back, and it looks like he's actually either skating over to join the conversation or join the penalty box. Haven't quite figured it out yet.
Yeah, I'm not sure exactly what he's doing. Obviously, he's a guy that you don't want to mess with, but not sure what his involvement in this particular situation is. But
there's both officials looking in the penalty box here, and Glenn Tamaris has his group across the ice getting ready for what could potentially be a power play opportunity or four on four, but at least the last 5.5 minutes of this period. Mike, thoughts on the first 15? As I mentioned, a lot of neutral zone battles, some big hits early on, but it's been a very even game, as you see by the scoreboard, 0-0, like England and the USA today.
That is correct. Yeah, very even period, back and forth hockey. I think, like I said, I think we actually had the better of the chances, a couple breakaways and a couple good opportunities right in front for us. But Danbury definitely getting some good chances as well. And now Mo Levac exits the penalty box.
Well, that's fascinating.
It really is. It's just, it's so complex you can't even keep up with it, Jacob.
Now this brings me back to my point from Wednesday night's game. If we got them microphones, we could know what they're also saying up here.
Jacob, you've never had a better, excuse me, you've never had a better point, but maybe it's just not in the budget. I'm not sure.
It might not be in the budget for the league. But it does look like both teams are heading to their respective benches. And they're going to figure this out. We'll get some numbers on it. And obviously the video board will give us a story on what will be the end of call here. I know it's probably roughing for a couple different guys. And now they normally don't see this, them heading right into the box to figure it out on the monitors. So they can get this together.
I have no idea what they're trying to do, but definitely I think it's going to end up being a power play for Elmira, just based on the fact that Danbury has two guys in the box as opposed to Elmira just having one.
Mike, it had the potential building of a full team brawl in the corner. We've seen a couple this year in the FPHL, and something to note, we actually saw one with a goalie fight the other day on Spit and Chicklets, the big Twitter and social media brand for hockey, ran by Paul Biznetti, and there was a goalie fight. You don't really see that too often in pro hockey.
No, it's a little more common in the FPHL than it is in the NHL. But, yeah, there's, especially Danbury, they like to fight. So I think we're getting some clarity here.
Do you think the building upon, that brawl in the corner there was because it is a 0-0 game to what many are saying the worst team in the FPHL is? The frustration building upon itself that they haven't been able to find one in the back of the net, and the Mammoth team is actually, skating up with them and playing to their abilities?
Jacob, I think you're exactly right. I think that Elmira's frustrating Danbury to a certain extent. You got guys like Golo out there who are, small, energetic forwards going into the corners, hitting people, getting Danbury kind of frustrated. Like, you know what? Hey, you're not supposed to be doing that, but Elmira's here to show them, yeah, we are.
So it looks like it's going to be 2 minutes even roughing for Nick Gulo and Jared Yao. And we have a 5-on-4 with the one penalty. Zach Pamilian and Nick Gulo and the one penalty going to Jared Yao. So Stavros Soyuz plays in the offense zone on the far side. This game's still tied up at zero. Just about 15 minutes played here at First Arena. Liriakos picks it up at the blue line, misses that one off his stick. Comes for Moskal. Moskal in the neutral zone for Levac. Levac passes in for Soyuz. This guy's just a bit offsides. They're going to have to move out of the zone. Pass sent all the way down. Proudlock comes out to play it. Leaves it back for Moskal. Exactly 5 minutes to play here at First Arena. 1:25 left on the power play as Moskal enters in the offensive zone. Plays it in the far side corner. Dahlin Anderson looked to skate on it. Levac holds it up at the point. Does come out, and it's Brendan Sheehan. See both teams with shorthanded opportunities. Sheehan in the offensive zone. He takes a shot saved by Proudlock with the pad. Pass over for Liriakos. Liriakos spins on the near side along the half wall. Pass up for Moskal. Moskal leaves it for Leeson. 4.5 to play. Leeson working in. He walks in, and he's held up. Big save there.
What a save there by Butler. I'm not sure how he got his pad on that, but that was a sure goal.
Mammoth back into the offensive zone. It's for Leeson. Leeson plays it out of the air. He takes that shot, that one, way wide. 35 seconds remaining here on the power play. 4:08 left here in the first period. Nathan Campbell pass up for Leeson. 3-on-2 the other way go the Mammoth. Leeson to the offensive zone. Pass down low for Moskal. Moskal takes a shot on that one across the crease of the net. Marsha Shane goes for Mock. Mock face guarded there by Campbell. Poke checked away by Nathan Campbell. Far side corner battle finally comes out for Jakub Wolf, who plays it back for Campbell, who goes up for the Michigan native Isaiah Crawford. Crawford's pass tipped off by Evan Lugo, comes back for Campbell. Here comes Zach Pamilian out of the box. Back to 5-on-5 hockey with 3.5 to play. Mammoth 0-for-2 on the power play tonight. Campbell walks in, he shoots right in the lap of Parker Butler, and we'll get an offensive zone faceoff here.
Both teams playing very solid defensive hockey. I mean, a couple little breakdowns that led to some breakaways and opportunities. But for the most part, both teams playing defense versus hockey here in the first period.
And with that, we're going to take our under 5 minute media timeout here at First Arena. Parker Butler, we talked about it in the pregame. This is his first ever FPHL start, first professional hockey start. And he's done a good job. He's faced some really tough shots. He's faced two power plays. He's done a good job in between the pipes for this Danbury team, who has two very good goalies with Frankie McLennan and Brian Wilson.
Yes, so far, make it three good goalies. Parker Butler's done a really good job. And like I said, he's a kid that played really good junior hockey, played in the NCAA, started in the NCAA. So, I think coming into this, he probably was ready to go.
And it's interesting because, last time we played this Danbury team, Brian Wilson, 7-0-1 on the season with a 2.44 goals against average and a 9.29 save percentage. A guy who's played up in the coast. Frankie
yes.
McClendon, 2-0 on the year, 2.1 goals against average and 8.75 save percentage. And he's played for a lot of different teams across this league. And they opted to go with their young goalie.
Yeah, I think you know, Billy McCreary probably saw this as an opportunity to get Butler a start. And so far, I think it's been a pretty good decision by him.
Dalton Anderson on the draw, won by Maritea. That shot on, still loose out of front. Rebound chance covered up by Parker Butler. Couple whacks at the puck there by Yakub Wolf and Isaiah Crawford. And good job protecting the crease was the netminder number 35.
Yeah, I think Isaiah Crawford there, he tried to tip it, and then the puck was just sitting back door, but it hopped right over his stick before he was able to tap it in.
Shot by Anderson, that one sent wide. Maritea dumps it right back in behind Butler. It's picked up by Kyle Gonzalez. Gonzalez through the defensive end. Lugo chips it through. Lugo plays it to himself. He works down the far side. Sends a centering pass. Shot by Kyle Gonzalez. Saved by Proudlock. Sent into the corner. Now just Dustin Jussieu on the puck. Goes out for Gibbs. Played down low for Lugo. Now it's Jussieu. Jussieu takes a shot on that one. Saved again by Proudlock. Under 3 minutes to play here. Maritea over for Wolf. Wolf crosses the red line and looks to play it himself as he plays chase. Gets to it. Now for Danilov. Danilov looked to take a shot on that one. Blocked by Gonzalez. Wolf centering pass for Levesque. Levesque shoots. Saved by Butler again. Parker Butler standing tall in the net for the hat tricks. Shots 14-11 in favor of Danbury.
Both goalies playing really well so far. Let's not forget the save by Thomas Proudlock on Dustin Jussieu at the other end of the ice. Big shoulder save right in the slot area, and then Butler responds with a save of his own.
Lyriakos catches it out of the air on a pass that hit the glass as it goes back for Levesque. Levesque dumps it right back in on the backhand for Lyriakos. Lyriakos out to the blue line for Levesque, who tries to kick it in. He's kept at his feet, battle along the half wall. Levesque keeps it in the offensive zone, heals the blue line, goes for Campbell. Campbell takes a shot on that one, sent wide. Comes all the way to the blue line. Becker dumps it right in. Lyriakos look for Dakota Seaman. It's kept in by Levesque. Levesque dumped down low for Lyriakos. That one wide to him. 2 minutes remaining in a 0-0 game. Sheehan stops at the red line and plays it through. Patrick's going to get a couple changes, new defensive pairs. Becker waits behind the cage, goes for Proudluck. Now for Campbell. Campbell, pass for Lyriakos, who's able to chip it in. Wholesale changes coming for the Mammoth as they get five new boots on the ground. Minute 30 remaining here. Marchand walks in. He takes a shot. That one saved by the stick of Proudlock. Played up for Parker Moscow, who just floats it over. Leeson looks to be the first one to get to it. He picks it up behind the cage. Leeson looks for a wraparound. Centering pass, Soyuz. That one played wide. Never reached Parker Butler.
Great block in front there by the Danbury Hatricks. I think two guys got a stick on it.
1:10 to play here in the first period. 3-on-2 the other way. It's Tristan Mock. Mock down the far side, has it on his backhand. He spins on a dime and drops it. Goes for Marchand behind the net. Out of the far side corner. It's played out to the blue line. Shot coming on that one. Wide of Proudlock. It was chipped just up and over by Mike Lopez. Bykarski, the first one to get to it. It's for Parker Moskal. Mammoth have a 3-on-2 the other direction. Moskal's held up. Pass down low for Soilus. He took a shot. That one saved. Bykarski scores! Tyler Bykarski with goals in back-to-back games, and the Elmira Mammoth take a 1-0 lead with just about a minute to play here in the first period.
Tyler Bykarski does it again. What a shot here by the right-handed defenseman. He got it, he let it go before Parker Butler was able to get set. The puck went off of a skate in front, came right to him, and he just let it go, put it on net, and good things happened for the Elmira Mammoth.
And Mike, if you remember back from the Wednesday game, the Bykarski goal almost came in the exact same situation. The puck bounced around a little bit in the high slot. Bykarski just took a shot on net, a harmless shot, and it was able to go up and over the netminder.
Very, very similar goals in back-to-back games for Tyler Bykarski.
30 seconds remaining here in the period as Daniluk just dumps it down, and Parker Butler will hold on to it for an offensive zone faceoff. And I think it's crazy that I talked about last game. It was just a couple weeks ago I talked to Tyler Bykarski, and he said, Jake, I don't score goals. I'm a defenseman that likes to block shots. I like to get deep, but I really don't shoot the puck that well. Well, now he has two goals in back-to-back games. The first one was his first ever pro goal, and now he has a second one just 2 days later.
Yes, it's got to be a fun time here for Bykarski, and
Moskal took a short-sided shot. Parker Butler able to get the glove up and looked like he pinned it underneath his mask.
Yeah, tricky shot there for Parker Butler to handle. But, yeah, Pekarski doing a great job in back-to-back games. First goal was definitely a little more on the luck side of things with the hitting off a stick and then going in, but that one was just a good shot.
Eason comes off the ice. Soilis takes the draw. That one going to be won by the Hattricks. Giles spins. Moskal dangles by, makes another move, plays it back for Soilis behind the net. He has that one caught up in his skates. Comes over for Cody Gibbs. Gibbs goes off the board. 6 seconds remaining here in the period. Dano dangles by, center and pass. Look for Dakota Seaman. Kuznetsov gets his skate on it. Puck goes fluttering up into the air. Kept by Soilis, but that's going to be the final horn here at the end of 20 minutes of hockey. The Elmira Mammoth get a first period goal, the second goal of the season from Tyler Pekarski with just 40 seconds remaining. And the Elmira Mammoth head into the locker room up 1-0. Mike, it was an even game through the first 19 minutes and 20 seconds, and then Tyler Pekarski finally broke the scoring.
Tyler Pekarski, red hot through two games with two goals as a defenseman. Great shot by him, but a really good period by the Mammoth in general. Obviously, Thomas Proudlock, 16 saves for him. He did a fantastic job. But Parker Butler, despite that one goal, which really wasn't his fault, he's doing really well too. So both goalies putting on a good show early on here.
Well, the Mammoth finally get their first win in franchise history on Wednesday night. And now after 20 minutes of hockey, they lead the first place team in the Empire Division, the Danbury Hattricks, by a final score of 1-0. Tyler Pekarski, as we mentioned, with the lone goal for Elmira. We're going to take a quick break. Don't go anywhere. Still 40 minutes of hockey left to play here at First Arena. For Jake Johnson, Michael Cosentino, we'll be right back. Good evening and welcome back to First Arena here in Elmira, New York. The Elmira Mammoth lead the Danbury Hattricks by a score of 1-0 after the first period here in Elmira. The lone goal scored by Tyler Pikarski in that frame. Jake Johnson alongside me, Michael Cosentino. And in a period that was back and forth for a majority of it, finally the Mammoth able to strike with just 40 seconds left to play in the period. Both teams had good chances shorthanded. Both teams had power play chances. And both defenses standing strong. And both goalies playing extremely well thus far. Thomas Proudlock in between the pipes for the Elmira Mammoth. And in his first career start, Parker Butler having a good night as well. We mentioned played for UMass Dartmouth from Summit, New Jersey. The 6'1", 181 goaltender doing a good job tonight in his first career start in pro hockey. And head coach Billy McGreary and Johnny Ruiz, the assistant captain and coach for this team, is also doing a great job, and they're obviously very happy with the way that their team has played thus far in this one as both teams retake the ice here at First Arena. As we mentioned, the Elmira Mammoth rocking their orange alternate jerseys for the first time this season. The Danbury Hattricks wearing their black uniforms. Frankie McClendon, the backup goalie tonight for the Danbury Hattricks. And this period obviously going to start with both Nick Gulo and Jared Yao in the penalty boxes. There was the brawl in the corner with just about 4 minutes to play, so shortly into the first period they should be coming out of the box for that one as both teams head to their respective benches. Head coach Glenn Tamaris, the message for that Elmira Mammoth team as I was down there is continue to play well, stay strong in the defensive end, and put more shots on Butler. They've taken a lot of shots, but they've been from the outside. They've had good chances, rebound opportunities, just not finding the back of the net other than that one from Tyler Pikarski, his second career goal in the FPHL. As we get ready for the draw here, it's going to be Dalton Anderson taking it against the birthday boy, Evan Lugo. Happy birthday to Evan. The Sandy Hook, Connecticut native taking the draw against Dalton Anderson. Both goalies set. And here we are for another 20 minutes in the second period. Mammoth lead 1-0, and they win that draw. Comes back for Marite, goes up for Dakota Seaman. Seaman plays up for Anderson. Anderson plays it in the air as it bounces up and into the zone. Picked up now by Kyle Gonzalez. Maritea working through the neutral zone, just plays it in as it goes and wraps around the boards into the near side. Volt bats it out of the air, plays it to his stick. Picked up now by Dmitry Kuznetsov, who goes for Justin Giseau. Giseau into the offensive side, dangles around the outside, stops in the faceoff circle, loses the puck. It's picked up by Maritea. Mammoth come 4-on-2 the other way. Maritea goes for Anderson. That one played off his stick. Seaman keeps it in the offensive zone. First 45 seconds gone here. Moscow throws a shot on net, sticked away by Parker Butler in the near side corner. Pass across for Kuznetsov. He goes up for Evan Lugo. Lugo over for McDonald. Pass center, but nobody there as Moscow goes up for Tate Leeson. Leeson and Abdella skate to get it. Parker Butler comes out of his net to play it. Solis dumps it down low, looking for Leeson. Leeson held up along the glass. It's backed in behind the cage. Luke Richards, the first one of that puck. McDonald plays it off the backboards. Moscow to the point for Solis. Solis plays it right back into him. He goes between his legs for Leeson. Into the corner. Picked up by the hat trick, Brendan Sheehan. Chameleon, now for Sheehan. Sheehan has that one bounce off his stick. He's able to play it, but it comes for Tyler Becker. Becker goes off the backboards looking for Pikarski. First one of that one as a shot's thrown on there. But it was blocked by Pikarski.
Great block by Tyler Pikarski there, getting in the lane, keeping that puck from getting to two Danbury guys that were in front of the Elmira net.
Parker Moscow waits in the defensive end, now tries a saucer pass up for Yanni Liriakos. It's batted out of the air by Michael Marchessault. Marchessault tried to move by Moscow. He has that one batted off his stick. Pikarski gets to it in the corner. Now it's worked behind the cage. Comes over for Tristan Mock. Tried to center and pass. Nobody home. Now Yanni Liriakos has Isaiah Crawford. It's flipped up in the air. Big play there by Gibbs to catch it and drop it to his stick. Marchessault looked to go low for Mock. Played over for Moscow. Moscow along center ice as he just flips it harmlessly into the air, sent all the way down. Yanni Liriaco skates onto it, leaves back for Crawford. Crawford walks in, he shoots, blockered away there by Butler. It's capped at the blue line by Campbell. He throws it down low for Liriaco. Liriaco's looking for a centering pass for Crawford. Goes off the backboard, just too far from him as Gonzalez picks up. His pass too far into the neutral zone, looking for Levac. Levac picks it up, has it on his backhand, strong, he walks in. And it's cleared all the way down. I'm gonna ice and call it. 16:56 remaining here in the period.
Brought you a little snack here, Jacob.
I see that.
They were handing out some chicken pizza back in, excuse me, back in the suite. So, you know, I'm a kind person, and I said Jacob would like a piece of that, so I brought it to him, and that's just what friends do.
It's just a massive chicken tender on the slice of, like, pita bread.
Listen, I didn't make it, but it looks pretty good.
No, I'm very happy you brought it for me, actually.
No, I could have ate it, but I didn't. I chose not to.
Are you sure you didn't have one on the way over?
I promise you I did not.
Okay. Face off. Played into the far side corner. Danilek chips it through, but first one of that one's Kyle Gonzalez. His pass whiffed on, goes for Seaman. Seaman, his pass is too far, and Anderson can't keep it in the zone. Seaman with a race for the puck. Goes for Marchessault. Marchand held off by Wolf. He loses his helmet, and that's going to be a penalty. Mock and Becker get into it a little bit right in front of the Hattricks bench. Wolf, the one who committed the penalty, standing all the way by himself in the offensive zone.
Yeah, Wolf's going to go off for high sticking here. I think it was an inadvertent play by him. Didn't try to get him up top, but just went for the stick lift and missed and hit him in the face.
Jakub Wolf, as you mentioned, the last game against the Delaware Thunder, had six blocks and three shots on net tonight. A couple shots on net, and I know he has two or three blocks. He's going to head to the penalty box, and we'll get a Vincenzo's Pizzeria penalty kill.
Vincenzo's Pizzeria, the best pizza in Elmira, even better than the pizza I brought Jacob up here, which was pretty decent. But Vincenzo's the best pizza in Elmira. Get over right across the street from First Arena to try the best slice in Elmira.
Mammoth one for one tonight on the penalty kill. It's going to be Evan Lugo taking the draw. He has Kuznetsov to his right, Sheehan to his left, just so behind, and Yao on the far side. Moscow, O'Connor, Leeson, and Pikarski out there as the penalty kill group. Leeson gets a stick on it, and it's batted into the neutral zone. Jusso holds him off, goes back for Yao. It's going to be an elbowing call to Jakub Wolf. As we have a battle in the neutral zone, no hands raised. Jusso and Leeson both went down. O'Connor goes up for Leeson. Leeson just plays it in. 1:30 remaining here. Moskal along the far side. He took a shot that went blocked by the referee. Now Danbury works up. It's Lugo. Lugo into the neutral zone. Leeson, another good poke check there. Now Jusso into the offense zone. He skates by Maritea. Look for a pass that Leeson finds. Leeson has Moskal to his left. Now Leeson skates to the far side. Takes a shot. That one saved with the pads from Parker Butler. 1 minute remaining here on the power play for the Hattricks. It's Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov tries to dangle by, but Anderson poke checks it off his stick, clears it all the way down.
Danbury's power play continues to struggle. Not so much in the offensive zone, but getting into the offensive zone. They can't even get set up.
40 seconds remaining on the penalty for elbowing to Jakub Wolf. Hattricks looking to set up as it's Jusso quarterbacking, and Anderson gets a stick on it but doesn't clear the zone. It's picked up by Gonzalez. Gonzalez down low for Jusso. Tried to get a pass across. Pikarski got a stick on it and batted up in the air. Campbell looked to clear it but couldn't get it off his stick. Able to poke it away from Richards. It's kept along the sideboards. Now on the far side, it's Gonzalez who goes down low for McDonald. McDonald goes for Richards, comes back to him. 10 seconds remaining here on the penalty. Now it's Jusso. Jusso walks in. He's on the far side. Centering pass. That one sent wide by Marchessault. Another shot on that one. Saved by Proudlock. Campbell clears it all the way down. Wolf comes out of the box. Bounces off the back wall, and Butler plays it. Mammoth get a much-needed change and another successful penalty kill. 2 for 2 on the night. Tristan Mock, as I mentioned, very speedy guy for this Hattricks team. Plays it in the offensive zone. It's sent to the far side. Amesbury, the first minutes we've seen him really get today. Low plays back for Daniluk in the defensive end. They go off the boards up for Lyriakos. Lyriakos passing the center for Gulo. Gulo now for Levesque. Levesque looked to take a shot on that one. Just poked off his stick, sent in. Now Connor Lind. Lind passed through, and Amesbury holds off Daniluk. It's Mock. Mock with a pass through that. Lopez couldn't get on. Good defense there from the Mammoth.
Great back check by Nick Gulo to get back. That would have been an easy tap and goal if Gulo didn't back check.
Gulo now working in the center as Xavier Abdellah is held up there. Lyriakos. Cross ice pass finds Gulo. Gulo into the offensive zone. He has Abdellah on him. He's played into the corner. Lyriakos looks to chip it through to himself. 13-12 remaining here in the period. Gulo still battling in the far side corner. Connor Lind on the puck. Pass for Abdellah. Finds Evan Lugo in the neutral zone. He's held up there from Tim O'Connor. Comes from Moscow. Moscow goes down with a hit from Abdellah. Now Kuznetsov the other way. Kuznetsov working through the neutral zone. Decides to spin back and going down hard there. Was an Elmira Mammoth. It looks like.
I think it's Tate Leeson.
It's going to be Tate Leeson. And as I mentioned, we didn't see too much action from Amesbury. And he finally takes the ice and immediately commits a penalty, Mike.
Just an unnecessary slash there by Amesbury. He obviously plays a chippy, tough game, but clear and easy call there for the official.
Tate Leeson now on the bench, sitting down with Sarah, the trainer, talking to him. We hope Tate Leeson's okay. He's been a really explosive player for this Mammoth team in the last couple of games.
Absolutely. Even in tonight, early on, couple breakaway chances, couple good saves by Butler, but he's definitely a guy you want to be able to have out in the lineup for the rest of this one.
So a Flynn power play now for the Elmira Mammoth with 12:49 to play. Already up 1-0 over the Danbury Hatricks. McDonald wins the draw, plays across for Lyriakos. Lyriakos looked to kick it through, but it comes all the way down. Proudlock leaves off for Moskal. Moskal with a pass that's picked up by Mock. He comes back in the neutral zone. That could have been a really unfortunate turnover there for the Mammoth. Patrick still working through it as out now. They skate through into the neutral zone. It's Sheehan and Soilus. So this plays back for Levesque. Levesque waits behind the cage of Proudlock. 1:24 remaining here on the power play. Levesque drops it back for Moscow, goes for Lyriakos. Lyriakos avoids a hit and jumps over. Lyriakos has Soyuz in the middle. Look to get it through, it finds Golo. Golo for Moscow. Moscow takes a shot on that one, sent wide. Still loose out in front and tipped in by Lyriakos! A bounce off the backboards that Lyriakos was able to just push through into the net. The Mammoth get a power play goal, and it's 2-0 over the Danbury Hatricks.
Wayne Gretzky said it, you miss 100% of the shots you don't take. Parker Moskal got the puck at the point. It didn't look like he had much, but he put it on net. When you put pucks on net, good things happen. Parker puts the puck on net, gets a good carom off the wall. Yanni tips it in, 2-0 Mammoth.
One of my best friends, Aaron Valentino, likes to say, pucks and people, Mike, pucks and people.
Absolutely.
So the Mammoth get another power play goal to add to their season total. With under 12 minutes of play here at First Arena, the energy picking up, fans getting into it. A team that won for their first time on Wednesday night now leads the first place team, the Danbury Hatricks, 2-0. Marshan comes the other way, face guarded there by Maritea. Tried to make a move by, stood up tall. Pass for Wolf. Wolf down low for Daniluk. Daniluk enters the offense zone, plays behind the cage. He's held up there by Gibbs. Wolf works his play by. Into the corner, it's Gibbs. Gibbs goes off the sideboards. And that one just extended too far from the sticky Jakub Wolf. Gonzalez plays it to the far side. Goes for Gibbs, now for Lopez. Finds a streaking Michael Marchand. Pekarski on him. He takes a shot that one up and over off the glass. Lopez able to keep it in the zone. It's Lugo. Lugo working the far side. He takes a shot. Proudlock saved. Still loose out. Now Abdel in the high slot. He takes a shot. Glove saved by Proudlock. What a save by Thomas Proudlock. Keeps the game in a shutout.
Great save there by Proudlock. Throwing up the leather, making a big glove save. And that takes us to immediate timeout.
Mike, do you notice a different energy in the building? Obviously, we talked about in the pregame the momentum building from scoring their first win in franchise history. But you're playing the number one team in the division in the FPHL in the Danbury Hatricks, a team that put up 8 goals on you the first time you played them, another 4 the next time, 12 goals in 2 games, and now with 11:07 to play in the second, they are up 2-0 over the first place Hatricks.
I absolutely agree, Jacob. I think that the win on Wednesday definitely gave a sense of belief and confidence to this group and to the people in the building as well. The energy has just really gone up to another level since Wednesday. And in that media timeout, Jacob, you could see Coach Billy McCreary for Danbury absolutely screaming at his players.
And this is a Danbury team, we talked about it, very aggressive group. They like to get physical. They like to put their body into the game to make an impact. And now down 2-0, your coach, Glenn Tamaris, you have to be telling your guys, don't do anything stupid. Don't get into a dumb boxing match out there with a guy and take a penalty that's going to cost us.
Yes, and we talked about it the other day, playing with the lead versus playing from a deficit. Right now, the Mammoth are playing with the lead. Not saying you don't want offense, you obviously still do, but you also have to not give Danbury any opportunities that they don't earn on their own.
O'Connor rattles it along the glass, and goes from the defensive zone to the offense zone, touched up by the Hatricks for a quick icing at 10:59. Another offense zone faceoff here coming for Danbury. Biscuit finally dropped as it comes out to the blue line, dumped down low by Lind. Pekarski, the first one on that puck. Pamilian goes down. Comes for O'Connor, who backhands it, looking for Soilis. Abdella faked the slap shot and then took one and batted off the stick of Savro Soilis. Played up for Tate Leeson. Leeson spins away from a hit. It's picked up in the neutral zone by Moskal. Moskal flips up for Pekarski. Pekarski already with one goal. As he works in, he takes a shot. That one blocked by Abdella. Some more words from the guy that Mikey kind of talked about. Not the most aggressive on the Hatricks team in Zach Pamilian, but getting into it there with Parker Moskal a little bit.
Absolutely. Much like Lance Hamilton, a Honolulu, Hawaii native in Zach Pamilian. Skilled player, definitely not the biggest guy on the ice, number 55. But he does have a good bit of energy to him, and he's not afraid to mix it up.
Hawaii taking over the FPHL. Who would have thought?
You know, it's funny. In junior hockey, we actually used to call Zach Hawaii. That was his nickname. And when I saw Lance, I said, wow, that was something I never thought I would see again, but I did.
Yeah. The Flying Hawaiian, as the Mammoth like to call him, as Mammoth do win the draw as it goes for Becker. Slapshot Campbell, that one blocked there by Jared Yao.
Big block there by Yao. The Mammoth had 2 net front guys. If that puck got to the net, there's a good chance the rebound would have been
Kulo
put on.
Kulo takes a shot there from the point, and Butler covers up. Offensive faceoff at 10:20 for Elmira, who are now leading in the shots column 20-18.
Yes, they are. Mammoth have absolutely outplayed the Hatricks this period, both ends of the ice. And, Jacob, I've noticed you haven't taken a bite of your pizza yet as he reaches for it. Oh, Jacob.
I'm just studying the large chicken tender on my pizza.
You study it any longer, it's going to be cold.
It will be a cold pizza. You're right. Hatricks win that draw as it plays back for McDonald. McDonald goes off the boards in front of the Mammoth bench, and it's back for Campbell. Campbell back into his defensive end to pick up for Becker. Becker on the near side goes across the crease of the mouth of the goal there, and it's played down. Iriakos looks down, skate, icing going to be waved off, didn't reach the red line back behind the cage. Near side corner, Liriakos and Levac to that puck as it comes out now. Jusso takes a huge hit there from Campbell.
Oh, no.
And they're going to get a penalty.
That's, oh, man, that's not a good call, man. They're going to give Campbell, No, sir, that's not. So they're giving him a hit from behind here, but that is not the right call by any means. Dustin Jusso, the guy who got hit on the play, turned. And a hit from behind is only a penalty if the guy has his back turned to you prior to you approaching him. If you approach him and he's facing you and he turns as you go to hit him, it's not a penalty. And once again, definitely a missed call there by the official.
Another Vincenzo's Pizzeria penalty kill here with just under 10 minutes to play. Nathan Campbell goes to the box with checking from behind. So he'll be in there for the next minute, 45. Richards, cross-ice pass, finds Gonzalez. That one blocked by Wolf, kept it in the neutral zone. Richards has to go pick up. Mike, we've talked about it. This Hattrick's power play has not looked the best tonight.
No, their power play is not bad once it gets in the zone, but they haven't been able to get that end zone presence and that consistency lately.
Richard dumps it in as Proudlock comes out to play. It leaves off for Volf. Volf with a pass up for Anderson. Anderson on his back is Pamillion. Pamillion's going to get called there, and we're going to go to 4-on-4 hockey at First Arena at exactly 9 minutes.
Good call there by the official, picking up an easy, easy trip call on Zach Pamillion. The Mammoth just having good pressure on the Hattricks right now. They have nothing going. Got to keep it up here if you're the Mammoth.
And Dalton Anderson obviously had one guy right in front of him. It wasn't clean ice. And then Pamillion coming on the back check. But we've seen already a couple times the Mammoth shorthanded have had chances tonight.
Absolutely. And I love Coach Damaris going with the Moskal-Leeson combination. Probably the two hottest players on the team as of recent.
Kuznetsov picks up the defensive end, works his way through the neutral zone with speed. O'Connor on him, Leeson back checking from behind. Shot on that one, blockered away by Proudlock. Comes from Moskal. Moskal has a streak to Leeson. It's 2-on-1. Moskal down the far side, pass for Leeson. Leeson walks in, 5-0, goal! Tate Leeson with another one! It's 3-0 Mammoth!
We just talked about it. Tate Leeson strikes again. Him and Moskal, the hottest two players on this team right now. Moskal gets the puck after a big defensive play in the other end. A good save by Proudlock. Moskal gets it to Leeson. Leeson with his patented five-hole goal, and it's 3-0 Mammoth.
Mammoth, Mike, I was just going to say that. Same exact goal as Wednesday night.
Same move.
Backhand, five-hole, and it just opens up the goal.
It absolutely does. Now, eventually, if you keep doing a move consistently enough in pro hockey, other teams will pick up on it, but Leeson just started doing it about a week ago, so he's got some time.
He tried it a little earlier today. Butler was able to close the five hole and make the save. Not as lucky as the second time. Mammoth 3-0 over the Hattricks. 8:33 to play. That was a 4-on-4 goal, so both guys obviously staying in the penalty box. We'll get a quick icing call at 8:29. Leeson with his fourth goal of the season. Moskal continues, has 24 points already coming into this one. Adds another assist on that. His 15th assist of the season and 25th point. Draw one by Elmira. We got a couple guys caught up at the faceoff dot. Abdella goes for Mock. Mock now for McDonald, back in the defensive end as they work through the neutral zone. It goes back for Tristan Mock. Mock with speed as he works down the near side. Mock spins in the faceoff circle, drops Maritea to a knee, leaves it for Jussieu. So now held up by Maritea. 18 seconds remaining on the penalty to Nathan Campbell. Mammoth work within their defensive end, finds a pass up for Gulo. Gulo has to skate down to get it. Gulo picks it up in the near side, goes to his backhand, spins along the faceoff dot. Centering pass, that one's batted up into the air. Nathan Campbell comes out of the box. It'll be a 45-second power play here for the Mammoth. Maritea leaves it off for Campbell. Gulo into the offensive zone, goes for Lyriakos. Gulo look to get it back for Campbell. He's taken down by Abdella. Coming the other way is Lopez. Lopez runs right into the officiating crew. And we have guys throwing sticks on the ice.
Oh, no, something happened. Oh my goodness. Something's going on the Danbury Hattricks bench. Somebody is very, very injured or hurt or something. I'm not sure. Coach Billy McCreary throwing sticks on the ice to try to stop play. You really hope that everything's okay here.
I don't know who the player is over there on the Danbury bench, but as soon as we find out, we will let you know as... Hopefully everything's okay on the Hattricks bench and something was seriously wrong. Sticks were being thrown on the ice and Billy McCreary just immediately wanted play stopped so they could get Sarah the trainer and the EMS out there. And let's hope everything's okay from the Danbury Hattricks bench, Mike. And with 7:24 to play, the Mammoth with a 3-0 lead, something that they really are not accustomed to this season. Obviously had it against Delaware. They had a 4-0 lead at the end of the first period. But now, against the Hattricks, a 3-0 lead, that's huge. That builds momentum, as we continue to say, a team that needs that momentum. This is a building it for them throughout the rest of the season.
Absolutely so, and they're bringing the stretcher out now. I'm not sure exactly what happened here, but a couple of the Danbury players, including backup goalie Frankie McClendon, are holding up a towel, attempting to kind of block the view of the fans. So obviously it's something pretty ugly, but once again, we weren't able to see what was happening up here in the booth, but Coach Billy McCreary and Captain Johnny Ruiz, who's not playing, who's on the bench tonight, were throwing everything they had onto the ice, sticks, gloves, waters, screaming, trying to get play to stop. So hopefully everything's okay.
Yeah, hopefully everything's all right over there on the Danbury Hattricks bench. As we mentioned, just 7:24 to play here in the second period. Mammoth leading the Hattricks by a score of 3-0. And once we have any information on the player that's down in the Hattricks bench, we will, of course, give it to you guys, so you know what's going on as well as we do. And right now, we're not sure what's going on down there, and we just hope everything's for the best.
I want to say, I don't like to speculate in situations like this, but based on the bit of a view that I do have, I think it's something in the facial area. Maybe a cut of some sort. Potentially why they're blocking the view from the fans. You know, when these type of things happen, the first thing your mind goes to is the player collapsed, something like that. And that was the reaction that the Danbury Hattrick staff were giving off. It was a very, very desperate reaction. But it's good to see whoever's hurt is now standing. So that's fantastic. But, oh, man, I'm not sure. He's moving very slow.
And it's going to be number 81, Tristan Mock, as they finally get him onto the stretcher. He was able to get up and climb over the board as he lays down, and we just hope everything's all right with Tristan Mock.
I did see Mock holding his chest as he got off. So, you know, once again, not trying to speculate, just hope everything is absolutely okay over there on the Danbury side.
As they now take Mock off the ice, you can see it up there on the screen now. If we have any further information later on in the game, we will of course give it to you guys. We just hope thoughts and prayers are with Tristan Mock, and hope everything's all right for him.
Great job by the medical personnel and the immediate response staff here at First Arena. Got out there as quickly as they possibly could, have Tristan off the ice, and he's in good hands.
So, Mike, as we mentioned, Tristan Mock injured there. Hope everything's all right from him, and still 7:24 to play here in the second period. Mammoth rolling as of late in this period, able to score 2 goals on the Hattricks. They are now still on the penalty. They're on the power play, for the next 24 seconds. A quick goal here, bring energy right back into the building.
Absolutely, Jacob. 3-0 lead is, I think, the first time the Mammoth have ever had a 3-0 lead. This, I think we had one last night against Delaware, but, this one is a little bit different because it's kind of been more of a slow burn. It's taken time for the Mammoth to get to this 3-0 lead. It's been a lot of good work in both ends of the ice, so hopefully they can keep it going.
Yeah, as you mentioned, it was 4-0 at the end of one against Delaware. That was a quick, obviously, 20 minutes already up 4-0.
Correct.
And now it's 3-0, but just still 7:15 to play as Danbury takes control of the puck. Just 10 seconds left on the Pamilion penalty. Proudlock comes out, sticks it into the corner. Yanni Liriakos goes to pick up, plays it for Campbell. Now Brennan Sheehan. Sheehan spins away from a hit. Pamilion comes out of the box, back to 5-on-5 hockey. Gibbs takes a shot that Proudlock catches in the glove, and he'll cover up.
position you're in right now as Elmira, you do not want to give anything up in these last 5 minutes here. You have a 3-0 lead, obviously. It's always good to have offensive pressure and keep it out of your end. But you can't have any defensive blunders here and let Danbury get back to a 2-goal deficit instead of a 3-goal deficit.
Pekarski plays it up. Gustavo Soyuz chases on. Soyuz gets to the puck in the far side corner, spins away from Gonzalez. Now it's picked up by Lisa, now a battle along the boards. Parker Moskal there as well as Gustavo Soyuz finally comes out for Cody Gibbs. Gibbs for the defensive end. Into the neutral zone for Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov with Tim O'Connor on him, tried to send a pass through, that one's blocked and sent in the corner. Pekarski picks up, goes off the boards for Soyuz. Soyuz now for Moskal. 2-on-1 the other way, it's Moskal and he goes down.
Great play there by Parker Moskal to chip the puck off the wall, hop around the Danbury attacker, and then draw that penalty, which brings the Mammoth to another power play.
Another Flynn power play here. First arena, that one's going to go to Luke Richards. And in a way, like, it was another 2-on-1 for Parker Moskal and Tate Leeson, something that's obviously been very scary for this group recently in the last two games. So, in theory, if they're able to kill this off, that's a good penalty to take.
100%, Jacob. I would definitely put that down in the category as a better penalty to take, stopping that chance for the Mammoth.
Moskal at the point, goes for Lyriakos. He winds up. His shot comes off the wrong end of his stick, but he's able to pick right back up, goes back low for Soyuz. Soyuz for Moskal. Back along the blue line. Moskal keeps it on the far side. He walks in. He shoots that one sent wide. Golo has it in the near side corner, goes for Lyriakos. Now for Levac, who goes back to him. Lyriakos along the faceoff die. He shoots that one. Deflects off Soyuz and has went wide. Lyriakos can't keep it in the zone. It's having Lugo come the other direction. Lugo into the offensive zone for the hat tricks. He takes a shot on that one wide. Took a carom off the backboards there. And Proudlock able to just get his skate on it. Soyuz can't get it through. It comes back into the neutral zone. Lugo plays it back for Gonzalez in the defensive end. 1:06 to play here in the period.
Danbury doing a good job of just holding this puck until right about there where they had to move it up the ice, killing some time off the penalty.
Lopez goes down in the corner. It's going to be a call against Parker Moskal. And with 52 seconds left on the Luke Richards penalty, Parker Moskal is going to head to the penalty box. Another 4-on-4 situation here at First Arena with 5:13 to play.
Pretty clear trip there by Parker Moskal. Obviously one that he would want to have back. Creates an opportunity here for Danbury to get off the penalty kill and into some 4-on-4 hockey.
Brings us back to that good penalty that this Danbury team took. They were able to kill the first minute and 8 seconds of it, and now they head to a 4-on-4, and if, you know, at the end of that, it's going to be a power play opportunity.
Yes, for over a minute they'll have a power play.
Kuznetsov, hassled there by Campbell. Campbell takes a slash at him. He's going to go down. Upcoming penalty here on the Mammoth. Butler skates off. Now it's Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov down the near side. Back around him. Becker goes down, and Kuznetsov keeps control. And the Mammoth finally able to touch up on the puck. But it's going to be Campbell who heads to the penalty box. 4-on-3 now for the hat tricks, with the potential of being 5-on-3.
Tough penalty to take there. Kuznetsov tried to get around Campbell. Campbell obviously didn't want to let him just walk right to the net. Trips him down, and then, yes, Danbury will have a 4-on-3 power play for the next 32 seconds, and then they'll have a 5-on-3 power play for about a minute and a half.
So the Mammoth penalty kill 100% tonight. As the draw comes out of the zone, McDonald has to skate back into the defensive end. Donald into the neutral zone for Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov working with Gonzalez as well as Jussot on the ice. Jussot goes for Gonzalez. Gonzalez in the high slot. He shoots that one, blocked by O'Connor. Goes up and into the netting.
Great block by Tim O'Connor. That's one of his best assets as a player, is his stick blocking ability. Defensemen are always supposed to try to get their stick up on the puck as guys shoot to deflect it away. Tim O'Connor's a big body. He uses a big stick. That's one of his best attributes.
You mentioned Dustin Jussot. 11 games played this season, 10 goals, 13 assists. Kyle Gonzalez this season, he has 4 assists on the year. Dmitry Kuznetsov, 6 goals and 3 assists. And John McDonald, another guy on that line, playing very well this season with 4 assists to his credit. So this team, this is a group that once they get hot, we talked about it when we played in Danbury, once they get hot, it's a scary group.
It is a, it's a very scary group. They have a lot of guys that contribute offensively. They're an older team, and they definitely, definitely can come back into this game. So if you're Elmira, you cannot take this lightly. But, Jacob, you almost forgot. This is a Vincenzo's pizza penalty kill.
Could never forget.
Yeah, and that slice of pizza I got you, now you're saying you're eating it because I told you to. But that slice of pizza has gone absolutely stone cold.
Uh-huh.
It's just unacceptable.
Draw won by the Hatricks. Comes back for Gonzalez. Gonzalez down low for Giseau. Richards comes out of the box in 4 seconds. It'll be 5-on-3 for the Hatricks. Now Giseau. He goes down low for Lugo into the slot. Saved by Proudlock. Still loose out in front and set wide by Levac.
Save of the game there by Proudlock. That was an unbelievable toe save.
Now Kuznetsov lines up, blocked by Mo Levac. And Levac able to get it clear. Moscow comes out of the box in 50 seconds. Kuznetsov shoots that one set wide to Proudlock. Kept in the zone, though, by Richards. Richards, QBing the power play, goes down low for Gonzalez, comes back to him. Kuznetsov lines up right into the chest of Thomas Proudlock, and he makes the save. Mike, this would be an absolutely massive penalty kill if the Mammoth could get it done. 30 seconds remaining on the Moscow penalty, 58 left on the Nathan Campbell penalty.
Yeah, what a save there by Thomas Proudlock. He's so athletic and quick at the same time. He's able to get his toe out there, make the save, and then follow it up with another one to get a whistle.
O'Connor, Anderson, and Pekarski, the penalty kill unit here for the Elmira Mammoth. O'Connor tries to play it through. It's batted off his stick, picked up by Richards. Richards goes for Yao. Yao down low for Sheehan. Sheehan now for Yao, who's working the point. He goes back and forth. Now he looks to line up, goes down low for Sheehan. Sheehan shoots low. That one just off the top of the netting, hit the water bottle on top of the cage of Thomas Proudlock. Sheehan keeps control, goes for Yao. Yao walks in, he shoots. That one goes up and over into the netting, and that one was deflected into the netting.
By Tim O'Connor once again. Great stick-on-puck action as a defenseman. That puck gets to the net. It's a very difficult save for Proudlock with bodies in front, but Tim O'Connor didn't even let it get to that point.
Whole new penalty kill unit coming out for the Mammoth. Moldovac comes back out with Chris Maritea and Dmitry Danilik. Just 11 seconds left. Tomasco comes out of the box. 20 seconds later for Campbell. Maritea shields his body away. That one's kept on escape by Yao. And
faceoff's going to come outside here because the Danbury player knocked the net off. So that'll be a huge break for the Mammoth, because now by the time the puck, if it does get back into the zone quickly for Danbury, Moscow will be out of the box and it'll be 5-on-4.
Now the official was yelling outside.
Okay, so did he not scream outside and put his hand up and point? I think they're just playing tricks on us today, Jacob.
Quite loud. Jared Yao leaves back for Sheehan. Parker Moscow out of the box now, back to a 5-on-4. Shot on that one, blocked by Danilik. Levac goes up for Moscow. Moscow with a lot of clean ice. Here comes Parker Moscow. Moscow walks in, he shoots, saved by Butler.
Great break for the Mammoth there. Great block, shots in front led to a chance for Moscow. Butler was up to the task, and he needed to make that save.
That kills a lot of the time, and now Nathan Campbell out of the box. Massive penalty kill for the Elmira Mammoth. And it was a 5-on-3 opportunity, and they're able to kill it off with 2:45 to play. And Proudlock takes the blue line shot for Pamillion, puts it in his glove, and he'll hold on to it and hand it off to the official for an offensive zone faceoff for the Hatricks.
Once again, Jacob, just to bring it back to, you said Wednesday's momentum, you can feel the energy in the building is just so much more alive than it has been in past games. And after getting that inaugural win off your back, you're able to really focus on what you can do as a group.
Danbury, pass turned over in the defense zone. Tate Leeson skating on with Xavier Abdella. Soilis touches up and we'll get an offside. Him and Marchessault, a little pushing and shoving action between the two. We saw Soilis go toe-to-toe the other night.
Marchessault being the guy that laid the hit on Noah Wild a few weeks back here at First Arena that has injured, not saying it was intentional, but it ended up injuring Noah Wild, breaking his arm and putting him out for a good while. So Stoilus obviously standing up for his buddy there.
2:28 to play here in the second period. Mammoth blinking the hat tricks, 3-0. Moskal has to come out of the circle. Conversation now between the linesman and Luke Richards and Mike Lopez. Stoilus and Marchand take the draw, and it comes out for Luke Richards. 2:25 to play here. Richards plays it in. Proudlock comes and puts on his stick. Becker plays it through. Comes out of the zone. First one to get it is Cody Gibbs in the neutral zone. Gibbs pressured by Leeson, goes cross ice for Gonzalez. Gonzalez goes up for Marchand. Marchand takes a hit there from Stoilus. Danbury throws it in the offense zone, and playing chase there was Richards. We're going to get a penalty here. It looks like it's going to be Tyler Beckert and Luke Richards still jawing at each other, but the official's in between the two, so it doesn't look like anything will come of it. But they both going to head to the box.
I think Becker's trying to get Richards to fight, but he won't go.
So just under 2 minutes to play, a tick under 2 minutes at 1:59. See if it's fours or fives here. We have one official holding up fives and then another one holding up fours. And it will be a 4-on-4 here for the next 2 minutes.
Yes, it will.
Moskal and Dassault take the draw. Daniluk plays it to the far side for Tate Leeson. Leeson picks up, flips it into the air, into the neutral zone. And that one is going to go into the Danbury Hattricks bench. It's a souvenir there for Johnny Ruiz. If he's not on the ice, at least he can get a free puck on the bench.
I think he has enough hockey pucks at home.
You think so?
I think so. If I had to guess, I'd say yes, he does.
So Sheehan and Moskal back in the Hattricks offensive end. And they win that one. It's Moskal and Leeson as they work up. Moskal tries a saucer pass across for Tate Leeson. Jared Yao, the first one to it, plays up for Sheehan. Sheehan goes for Yao. Yao in the neutral zone. He just plays it into the corner. Yao skates on with Maritea. Daniluk plays him on the ground, and we're going to get another penalty on Dmitry Daniluk.
I think the stick just got tied up there for Daniluk, and Danbury Hattricks player went down. Daniluk doesn't like the call, but either way, we're going to have 4-on-3 hockey here in favor of Danbury. And this, Jacob, brings us to another Vincenzo's Pizza penalty kill. The best spot in Elmira for pizza. Make sure you get over to Vincenzo's, get a slice. My personal favorite being the chicken wing pizza. It's great stuff. Official pizza sponsor of the Elmira Mammoth.
Lekarski tries to get it clear, but it's Captain McDonald at the blue line. 1:25 to play here in the second period. Mammoth lead 3-0. McDonald goes low for Gonzalez. Gonzalez back to McDonald. Working a point for Kuznetsov down the far side. Centering pass Gonzalez. Back to McDonald. He shoots. That one blocked in front by Levac. And Levac just can't keep it out of the zone. McDonald, good job at the blue line. Down low for Kuznetsov. Pekarski gets down to a knee to look to block. Comes to the top to McDonald. McDonald and Gonzalez going to switch places. McDonald goes for Kuznetsov. He shoots. Saved by Proudlock.
Proudlock has been rock solid this game, not allowing anything by him. And he's doing a good job of controlling the shots, not letting rebounds fly all over the ice. That's a tough shot up top on your chest to hold on to, but Proudlock did a great job.
Proudlock, 24 saves in this one. Comes back to Gonzalez. Gonzalez shoots on, another save. Proudlock comes into the chest of Levac. Levac shields his body away, tries to get it clear, and we're going to get another whistle. This one's going to go on the Hattricks. And it looks like it's going to go to number 27, Brendan Sheehan.
It is going to be a slash on Sheehan. And that's what happens when you play good defensive hockey. You frustrate a team. Eventually they start getting desperate. They start taking penalties, doing things that they typically wouldn't do. And now we're going to get something very rare. We're going to get three-on-three hockey, Jacob.
Three-on-three hockey, and it's not overtime.
You know, for the next, do some quick math here.
Come on, give it to me.
47 seconds.
Give it to me.
How do you know about all where I went? What have you been looking up?
Pekarski takes a draw now for Leeson. Leeson walks in. He shoots, saved by Butler off the head. Leeson into the corner. 40 seconds to play here in the period. Leeson hounded by two Hatricks defenders, and he's going to throw a jab at Zhao. Yao goes down, and it's going to be a 4-on-3 the other way. Jussieu walking in. Butler skates to the bench now, 4-on-3. 20 seconds to play. Jussieu shoots that one, saved by Proudlock. Still loose out in front. Kuznetsov works in. He shoots, saved by Proudlock. The goalie standing on his head tonight in the purple and orange, making save after save, and Tate Leeson joins his friends Dmitry Daniluk and Tyler Becker in the penalty box. I don't know if there's enough room in there for all three of them.
Not three of the biggest guys of all time, but definitely going to be a tight squeeze in there for sure. But let's talk about Thomas Proudlock. I mean, he has made so many good saves tonight. And once again, makes the first save, puck goes out, gets his glove on it, holds on to the puck, is able to get a much-needed whistle for the Elmira Mammoth. He's just doing a fantastic job.
So with 13 seconds left, it's going to be a draw one by Levac. Campbell winds up. That one's blocked and kept in the zone by Kuznetsov. Campbell waits, now sends it all the way down, and that'll be the end of the period with just 3 seconds left. Time will tick down, and after 40 minutes of hockey here at First Arena, the Elmira Mammoth lead the first-place Danbury Hatricks by a score of 3-0. Mike, another complete period from this Elmira Mammoth team, offensively, defensively, in between the pipes. The team is playing the best that I've seen it.
By far the best that the Elmira Mammoth have ever played this season. Thomas Proudlock holding the fort back there. And when you have a goaltender making saves like that in the net, it gives the rest of your team confidence. It gives your forwards confidence that they can do what they want down in their own end and that they can be creative. It gives your defense confidence that, you know what, if something happens, my goalie's going to have my back. So when you have good goaltending in net, it just creates all sorts of great things for your team.
We're going to head into the break here. Elmira, as I mentioned, up 3-0 over the Hatricks. Goal from Tate Leeson in that period. Another five-hole beauty, and Yanni Liriakos tipped in the other off a shot that careened from the back of the wall right to his stick. And the Mammoth tally two more. We're going to head to a quick break here, but when we come back, 20 minutes of hockey left. The Mammoth looking to get on a two-game win streak and take down the first-place Bunnies. We'll be right back. Welcome back to First Arena here in Elmira, New York. The Elmira Mammoth with just 20 minutes left of hockey to play here tonight. They lead the Danbury Hattricks by a score of 3-0. Recap of the goals in the second period. Yanni Liriakos with a goal that careened off the back of the wall from Parker Boskell, and Stavros Soyas with an apple on that as well. And then for the third goal of the game, it was Tate Leeson and Parker Boskell once again. Leeson went to the backhand, slid it 5-hole on Parker Butler for the third goal of the game. And the Mammoth lead this one 3-0. And as we talked a little bit about it in the break, Thomas Proudlock, you can't even say enough adjectives to describe the way he's played tonight.
I agree. Proudlock has been the backbone of this Mammoth game so far. It has done a great job controlling the puck, making big saves when he needs to. He's had a couple really big stops in front of the net. At the same time, I would like to give credit to the entire team for playing much better defensively in front of Proudlock. You know, a low goals against average as a team, you know, that's a team statistic. That's, you know, goals against average is a team statistic. So as good as Proudlock is doing, and he is doing fantastic, the Mammoth team has really bought in and is playing good shutdown defense, blocking shots, clogging lanes, and not allowing any uncontrollable plays for Proudlock, giving him a chance to make the saves.
As before we get puck drop, let's take a quick look around the FPHL. The Binghamton Black Bears up 5-3 over the Port Huron Prowlers. The Carolina Thunderbirds and Watertown Wolves tied up at 3. The Motor City Rockers up 5-2 on the Delaware Thunder. And the Columbus River Dragons up 3-1 over the Mississippi Seawolves. And obviously, the game here at First Arena, the Mammoth lead the Hattricks by a score of 3-0. And Mike, we were talking about beforehand your knowledge of math and your skills at King's College and Newman. So we got a lot of people in the penalty box. Let's figure this out. What are we going to start with at the end of this period?
Oh, this is a tough one. I'm looking at the thing. This is like a question on a test where you say, oh, I'll come back to that one. Well, after 1 second, why do you ask me these things? I can't see.
So Tyler Becker and Luke Richards will both come out of the box in 1 second. Then 31 seconds later, it'll be Dimitri Daniluk coming out of the box. A minute 14 later, it will be number 27, Brendan Sheehan. And I believe Tate Leeson's down there somewhere in the penalty box trying to figure it all out. But we're going to start the period 4-on-3 in favor of the Hattricks. And I think it'll continue that way until 31 seconds when Dimitri Daniluk comes out. Then it will be a 4-on-4. And then it'll be another minute 14. Sheehan will come out, and I think they'll probably have like a 20 or 30 second power play with Tate Leeson in.
That sounds about right.
All right, thanks. My 4 years at SUNY Oswego probably covered that for me.
Oh, yeah, sure. I did a great job.
I haven't taken a math class since 2018 freshman year, so.
You know, he really did all that math during the intermission, guys. He didn't just do it on the fly. It took him a half hour, so.
Yeah, you're right. I sat here the entire intermission and tried to figure out this.
Three pieces of scrap paper later.
Broke my pen. It was frustrating. As it looks like the official's still trying to figure everything out here. Now it looks like we're ready for puck drop at First Arena. It's going to be Dalton Anderson and Evan Lugo. And Lugo wins that one. Just looks like Richards will now come out of the box. So now 5-on-3 the other direction for 20 seconds. So I was still wrong with my math, folks. proves to you math is not fun. Kuznetsov into the offensive zone. 13 seconds till Daniluk comes out of the box. Kuznetsov circles to the other side, takes a shot. Pad save, Proudlock. And we are going to have another penalty. Just complicate things with more math. It looks like this one's going to go on the Elmira Mammoth. Luke Richards still down in the corner on the far side. Now Becker comes out of the box. It looks like it's going to go to Tyler Piekarski. Not how you wanted to start the first 27 seconds
no.
of this period.
Really not. I believe this is going to be a high stick. Let's hope there's no blood, because if there is, it's going to be a 4 minute.
Luke Richards has been beaten and battered tonight. He spent probably about 4 or 5 minutes in the penalty box. Now we've got a high stick. He's been heading some pushing and shoving. Luke Richards is probably ready for these final 20 minutes to be done, so he can hop back on the bus to Danbury and have a nice sleep tonight.
I was going to say, he's a pretty tough kid, and he's showing blood now to the official. I don't know if you can do that after the fact. He is bleeding, but So for those of you who don't know, a high sticking penalty typically is a two-minute call. If there's blood, if the high sticking call draws blood, then it gets bumped up to a four-minute. But I don't think the refs want to hear it. I think they're just going to stick with the initial two-minute call.
So,
which is really, to be honest, is the wrong call. It should be a four-minute if there's blood, but ref's still trying to get things figured out here.
So, it is a Vincenzo's Pizzeria penalty kill. Dimitri Danilek will come out of the box in 4 seconds, and then I believe we'll get a 5-on-4. There's so many numbers on the screen right now, we can't tell if it's a four-minute or a two-minute issue to Tyler Pekarski. But we're back to it. John McDonald takes a shot. That one saved off the bucket of Thomas Proudlock. Now another shot on that one sent wide. Still 5-on-3 on the ice. McDonald for Lugo. Lugo cross ice for Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov walks in. He goes down low looking for Lugo. Connor gets his stick on it. Still kept in the zone though by McDonald. Goes for Richards. Richards tried to get a pass through. Levesque, huge defensive play. O'Connor gets it clear.
Big play by Levesque there to pressure the point man for Danbury so he couldn't settle the puck. That led to the clear.
So still 5-on-3 here, trying to figure everything out. Leeson looks like he's the next to come out of the box. Danilek now back to sitting down. Numbers on the video board wrong here at First Arena. 18:40 to play. Drop pass there for Richards. What a toe save there from Proudlock. Put the pad out, makes the save, and covers up the puck. That was massive.
Big stop there by Proudlock. Once again, a good job by the Elmira Mammoth, not allowing anyone to get right to that slot area. There was a shot kind of from the bottom of the circle there, but the Mammoth were right around to take care of Proudlock and let him cover it up.
Dimitri Danilek does come out of the box now, so.
Yeah, the refs don't have this one under control.
Yeah, it's a lot happening here at First Arena. 18:30 to play. Leeson looks to be the next to come out with 30 seconds remaining on his penalty. Picked up back behind. Official blocks the centering pass as it comes out to the point for Gonzalez. Gonzalez goes over for Yao. Yao back to the point for Gonzalez. Gonzalez over for Yao. Yao and Gonzalez going to switch places. He winds up, goes for Gonzalez. 12 seconds remaining until Leeson walks out of the box. Slap shot coming. Yao makes the save. Proudlock still loose out in front. Rebound chance, and Mariteo looks to get it clear. It does come out, but not far enough. Pamilia over for Gonzalez. Gonzalez goes down low, centering pass. Proudlock makes the save. It's up on top of the cage and bounces wide.
What a save by Proudlock. He got the glove on it somehow.
Leeson now onto the ice. Pamilian, he walks in. Still loose out in front. Another shot, another save. Proudlock. And now a goal. Lopez had the rebound chance. Proudlock made the first two initial saves. And Mikey Lopez gets another one. It's now 3-1. The shutout gone from the Mammoth. And that'll be a power play goal for the Hattricks. Lopez, his first goal of the season.
Nothing that Thomas Proudlock could have done there. To be completely honest, Danbury should have scored about 15 seconds earlier than that. What a glove save Thomas Proudlock made going post to post. And then it was just a mad scramble at the front of the net. Tough play. It's a 5-on-3 or a 5-on-4 at that point. 3-1 Elmira.
So 17:38 to play now, and both teams finally back to 5-on-5. Haven't seen that in quite a while here. Shot on Proudlock, he makes the save. He'll cover up at 17:28.
Obviously a huge goal there for Danbury. Brings them back into a reasonable deficit from what was a 3-0 deficit. And if the Mammoth had gotten on top even more, the game would have been completely out of reach. So that's a huge goal for Danbury.
Offense zone faceoff kept in by the Hattricks. Played down low. Pekarski, the first one onto it. Into the near side. Now Lugo drop down low for Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov unable to get to that one. Soilus just flips it up into the air. Moskal looking to skate on, but he's held off there by John McDonald. Leeson picks up in the offense zone. Leeson takes a shot and a goal! Tate Leeson with his second of the night, and the Mammoth respond immediately.
Tate Leeson strikes again. This wasn't the hardest shot in the world. It was just placed absolutely perfectly. I think there was a screen in front. I believe the Danbury Hattricks defenseman, number 6, got in the way. of Butler being able to see that shot, and Leeson just placed it in the right spot and gets a huge goal to get that three-goal lead back for Elmira.
Just like that, the Elmira Mammoth lose the shutout, but they score right back and make it 4-1. Tate Leeson scores his second of the night, makes it his fifth of the season. And I believe that one will probably go down unassisted for Tate Leeson. It's now 4-1 with 16:50 to play. Now working up with it, it's Cody Gibbs. He takes a shot on save by Proudlock. He pulls it back in with his stick to cover. So I was, apparently I was wrong about the unassisted. Someone on YouTube, please rewind, because I don't know where the assist was, but they went to Parker Moskow and Tim O'Connor. If that's true, Moskow continues to add on to his point total, and I believe that's going to be Tim O'Connor's first point of the season. But we'll get an official word on that. Marcia Shan dumps it in. 16:30 to play here. Mammoth lead 4-1 over the Danbury Hatricks. Becker pass over for Campbell. He was looking for Gulo. Stretched too far from him. It's dumped back into the offensive zone. Becker catches out of the air. He goes down. 2-on-1, it's Lugo. Lugo walks in. He looked to make a pass through. Now he's on the ground. Lugo can't get it off his stick, and it's played all the way out wide. Gonzalez keeps it in at the point. Sliding Liriakos. He goes by him. And it looked like Mike Lopez broke his stick as he tried to pass it for Gibbs. He's got to head to the bench, get a new twig. It's passed up from Marsh Shan, too far from him. Gulo just dumps it into the offensive zone. Amesbury with some action here. We haven't seen too much of him tonight, coming off the 8-game suspension. Battle in the neutral zone picked up by the Mammoth. Maritea plays it for Crawford. Crawford looked for Wolf off the end of his stick. Kuznetsov dumps it in. Proudlock comes out to play it, and he goes down. Amesbury right through Thomas Proudlock. Maritea now getting into it with Amesbury. Battle behind the net. And you saw something like that coming, Mike.
Yeah, that's just a dirty play by Amesbury. He's obviously out there to stir the pot. Goes after the goalie. Now Gesso going at it with Crawford in front of the net.
Amesbury just absolutely plowed over Thomas Proudlock. Well, he had the puck covered. He's going to head into the box along with Chris Maritea. It looks like Crawford's going to join them. Crawford and Gesso jawing back and forth in front of the box. More penalties here, and the good news about this, Thomas Proudlock upstanding, putting his helmet back on. He seems to be okay after the incident.
He is okay, and I understand Amesbury wanting to stir the pot a little bit. You know, that's his responsibility as an enforcer to get out there and try and make things happen, especially when your team is losing. But going after the goalie, that's just, you know, there's no need for that. Obviously great to see Proudlock getting up and being okay, and I believe this has to result in a power play for Elmira once everything's said and done.
Interesting to note, Daniel Amesbury taking, seems like, all of his pads off now, putting his jersey back on, took his chest protector off, seemingly doesn't need it from the penalty box.
Once again, not sure what the holdup is here. It should be pretty simple. I guess they're going to give Amesbury and Matea some roughing majors. Not sure why Gesso's in the box. I guess he took a shot at Crawford, but
it looked like after the play, Gesso and Crawford going at it with each other, words exchange, couple shoves, so they'll probably be 2 minutes each way. We'll see what the final call is. As we said, I don't really get a mic to tell us what actually happens. We just see numbers appear on a video board. And we've also seen that those numbers prove to be incorrect.
Yes, that
so
is.
So that seems to be an issue for us here tonight in the First Arena press box for Jake Johnson and Michael Cosentino.
Yes, it is. It looks like Amesbury is going to get the 2 minutes there for roughing Thomas Proudlock, which will put the Mammoth on a power play, in which they have an opportunity to put this one away here with a power play goal.
15:23 to play, up 4-1 over the Hatricks, a 3-goal lead. Back on the power play, already 1 goal tonight for them, coming from Yanni Liriakos when he tipped it in to the back of the net, pass Parker Butler. me and Mike talk about this power play unit for the Mammoth has been lethal this season. Once they get hot, pretty hard to stop this group with Gullo and Soilus, Levac, Moscow, and Lyriakos.
Yeah, it's a power play that actually, as we talked about before, has been pretty good all year despite not winning too many games in the beginning of the season for the Mammoth. But adding Nick Gullo to this power play unit and Mo Levac, which was a little bit more in the past, but adding Gullo to this power play has really added a quick, speedy, gritty element that allows him to do some work, get the puck to the goal scorers in Moscow and Lyriakos.
And the interesting thing to note about the Mammoth power play, no defensemen, all forwards out there. As Moscow takes a shot on right into the lap of Parker Butler, he'll cover up 5 seconds in, a quick shot for Elmira.
Only Butler's second shot of the period. That one and the Leeson goal, the only two he's faced so far.
Gullo back out to take the draw. Moscow behind him. Now we're going to be won by Gullo. Goes for Levac. Now across for Lyriakos. Lyriakos with a lot of time. Walks in, shoots that one wide and wraps around to Levac. Levac on the near side. Stops at the faceoff circle. Goes to the blue line for Moscow. Moscow and Levac switch places as he works down low. Moscow missing his stick now. He was slashed out of his hand. No call coming from any of the officials. Moscow skates off to go get a new stick.
The stick was actually broken off of the slash. Not sure how the refs missed that one.
Levac holds it strong. Now he works his way in. Tried to drop it down low for Soilus. And Moscow lays a massive hit, and that's going to be a penalty. Now Soilus in some pushing. Things getting pretty physical here between these two teams.
Moscow going to get 2 minutes for charging here. Mammoth power play will go away. We'll have 4-on-4 hockey for a minute and 17 seconds. And Jacob, you're absolutely right. This game's starting to get very chippy in the final 15 minutes.
So 14:40 to play. It's going to bring the faceoff draw and null the Mammoth power play that they had back to 4-on-4. Still a lot of time to play here, Mike, in this period. And between these two teams, it's getting this chippy with still a lot to play. Things could get out of hand here.
Yes, they could very easily, and obviously you don't want to see that for either team. Both teams have games tomorrow. Both teams on the road, I believe. Danbury's on the road too, so, you know, you want to get out of this one harm-free on both sides.
Becker, a battle in the corner with Pamillion. Luke Richards there as well. It's played out. Now a slap shot coming. McDonald, wrong end of his stick, sent up and over into the glass. So 4-on-4 hockey here. Danbury controlling the puck in their offense zone as Gonzalez plays it down low for McDonald. McDonald with Lyriakos working towards him, sending the slot for Gonzalez. He shoots, saved by Proudlock. Now Campbell, pass up for Lyriakos, stretched too far from him. McDonald skates back to get it. Pass up for Richards, now Gonzalez. 2-on-2 the other way go the hat tricks. Pass up for Pamillion. Pamillion looked to make a move by O'Connor. He's held up. 42 seconds till Mike Lopez comes out of the box, serving the penalty to Amesbury. Now it's McDonald in the near side. He takes a short side to Sot. Gullo with the puck behind him. Didn't know it was coming. Gonzalez able to get to it first. Puck set flying up into the air. Gullo now goes down with a hit from Pamillion. Able to hand it off for Tate Leeson. Leeson to the defensive end now. Lopez comes out of the box in 13 seconds. Leeson in the offense zone. Pass across Anderson on his backhand. Set in front. Looking for Leeson's hat trick. He was unable to get to it. It's Kuznetsov the other direction. Now Leeson goes down hard in the neutral zone. It's going to be a penalty. Leeson slides all the way from the center logo ice down to the defensive end.
So Leeson going to get 2 minutes for holding here on the back check. He ripped down Kuznetsov. But just before that, on that two-on-one, Leeson was hooked very, very badly in front of the net, not allowing him to tap in that pass. It was coming across, I believe, from Yanni Lyriakos. So definitely a missed call there from the ref, and then they decide to give Leeson one on the back check.
There's not enough room on the bench in the penalty box, so Tate Leeson has to sit on the water jug now. Four guys in there for Elmira, three for the hat tricks. It's going to be a 4-on-3 for the next 3 seconds. Lopez will come out of the box, 5-on-3 for the next 46 due to the penalty to Parker Moscow. This penalty kill brought to you by Pikarski able to clear it all the way down. Lopez comes out of the box to join his squad. Now a 5-on-3 for the next 40 seconds till Moscow comes out. 13-16 to play.
Sorry, huge penalty kill here for Elmira.
Kuznetsov loses his edge, and Levac controls it in the neutral zone. Now it's sent up for Sheehan. Sheehan in the offense zone, pass across for Mike Lopez. Lopez back for Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov winds up. That one's blocked by Levac. 17 remaining here on the 5-on-3 on the Vincenzo's Pizzeria penalty kill. Lugo, cross-ice pass. Big tip there from Levac. Lopez was sitting on the back doorstep. Shot by Yao. That one sent wide. Moscow comes out of the back box 5-on-4. Now Lugo. Lugo shoots, saved by Proudlock.
Looked like Proudlock wanted to play that one with his paddle and try and clear the zone. Ref had a bit of a quick whistle, and now O'Connor going at it with somebody. Jared Yao, I believe.
And both Marite and Crawford come out of the box for their equal two-minute penalties, as well as Dustin Jussot coming out of the box.
You know what we almost forgot?
No, I said it.
Did you?
Vincenzo's Pizzeria penalty kill?
The best spot for pizza in the city of Elmira. Get over to Vincenzo's. Their pizza is great. I know pizza. Worked in restaurants my whole life. Get over to Vincenzo's. Try the best pizza in Elmira.
Garden State Food Reviews, right?
You had to bring that up on the air, didn't you?
On the air.
Yep, my YouTube channel I had. Shout out to my mom, who's definitely listening. My mother works at Jolione's Italian Specialties, which is an Italian specialty store in New Jersey, and she makes the fresh, as you guys say, mozzarella.
Mozzarella.
Mozzarella. Mozzarella. And she does a great job. Mom, love you. Miss you. Made a great Thanksgiving yesterday. Can't wait for Christmas.
So 109 remaining on the Tate Leeson penalty. So a 5-on-4 coming for the Hatricks, down 3 goals here at First Arena with 12:34 to play. Pikarski now goes down hard in the corner, picked up by Luke Richards. Richards back for Gonzalez, who switches with him. Now Richards takes a shot on that one, blocked up into the netting. Mike, I don't know if on your piece of paper over there you count blocks, but the number has to be in the high 20s, low 30s for blocks of this Elmira Mammoth defense.
Absolutely, Jacob. Everybody is doing it, too. It's not just one or two guys. Everyone's buying in. Everyone's putting their body on the line.
Face-off win by the Hatricks. It's Pamilian. Pamilian down the far side. He walks in, stops with the face-off, switches places, goes for Gonzalez. Gonzalez takes a shot. Proudlock was screened out in front, able to stick with it and make the save.
Proudlock is trying to play these pucks. I think that one might have been a little bit of a risky play. But the reason he's trying to play them, for those of you who might be confused, is he wants to prevent these offensive zone face-offs for Danbury. He's trying to clear it to the corner so RD can get it and send it down the ice. And then it almost acts as a face-off win for Elmira.
Danbury wins that one. O'Connor shields his body away with Sheehan. Sheehan loses his stick. O'Connor tried to throw it off the glass. Now he officially will, and it goes all the way down. Tate Leeson banging. His hands are on the glass in the penalty box. 25 seconds remaining on his penalty. 11:50 here in the game.
Tim O'Connor is my defensive player of the game tonight for Elmira. He's been fantastic in all assets.
Gonzalez with a drop pass for Sheehan. Sheehan into the offensive zone, pass for Jussot. Jussot goes down low now for Brendan Sheehan. Sheehan works behind Proudlock for Kuznetsov. Gonzalez working the point. Goes for Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov walks in, takes a shot, saved by Proudlock. Leeson comes out of the box. Another successful penalty kill for the Mammoth. Another shot on that one, sent wide. Anderson plays it off the glass, and that one will get a wholesale change for the Mammoth. Leeson face guarding in the defensive end. Leeson creates a turnover, skates it back in the neutral end, and throws it in. Butler wraps it through with his stick. Moskal looked to create a turnover, but it's picked up by Jussot. Jussot goes to the far side for McDonald. Under 11 to play. It's Lugo up for Marchesan. Marchesan has that one bat off his stick. Lugo takes a shot, saved by Proudlock, and he'll lay on top of it for another offensive zone draw. I'm like 39 shots for the Hatcher. Thomas Proudlock has made 38 saves tonight for the Elmira Mammoth.
It's an outstanding performance by him. Once again, 38 saves on 39 shots is an incredible performance so far. At the same time, the entire Mammoth team is playing good, solid defense. It's just a great team effort, goaltender included.
Soilis goes up looking for Leeson. Moskal dumps it in. Leeson took a slash there. Stayed on his feet as he heads to the bench. Now he goes down by Michael Marchand right in front of, and now we have a brawl happening. Soilis and Moskal thrown to the ground. Punches being thrown all over the place right in the new offensive zone. Daniluk trying to pull players off. Still going at it with Stavros Soilis, I believe.
Oh boy, Leeson not doing well over by the bench. He's struggling to even stand up. That was such a cheap shot. I'm not sure who did it, but that's what caused Soilis.
It was Michael Marchand with the cheap shot.
Oh my God, wow.
Soilis cut open. He was battling on the ground with Jared Yao. Things getting really physical. Soilis bleeding again. He cut the same spot Wednesday night in his battle with Basie on the Delaware Thunder. Yao's gonna head in. Danilik's gonna head in. Marchand's gonna head in. Leeson is now headed to the locker room. A guy who's played an absolutely phenomenal game tonight for the Elmira Mammoth has been hit senseless amounts of times all over the place. Slashed, hit right in front of the bench. Tate Leeson has played an outstanding game with all he's been through in this 60 minutes of hockey.
Tate Leeson's been outstanding. And I have to say, it is really, really upsetting to see a player injured sitting on a stretcher right now in the hallway. Clearly not doing well in Tate Leeson. And just because a player wants to take a cheap shot because you're losing, I mean, there's just no place in this league or hockey in general for those type of plays. It's just totally unacceptable. And you have a guy like Tate Leeson who's working hard every day, doing a really great job for this team, having a breakout point in his career, and now he's potentially sidelined because of an injury that was totally unnecessary and was just an emotional reaction by a Danbury player.
There's still 10:28 to play, Mike. It felt like it was 20 minutes ago I said to you, hey, there's 14 minutes left, things are getting physical. Well, about 3 minutes later, things continue to get physical here, and that one resulted in a brawl right in front of Thomas Proudlock. Tate Leeson on his way to the locker room. Multiple guys in the penalty box.
And there's a difference between a game getting physical in a healthy way and a game getting chippy. And this game has gotten chippy. You don't see too many guys actually laying hits. What you're seeing more so is these emotional reactions, guys taking cheap shots at players, and that's just, like I said, obviously we hope Tate Leeson, he's still on the stretcher right now from the angle I have. You hope he's okay, but there's just no place in the game for that type of stuff.
The good news for Tate is he is sitting up. He's obviously alert. He's talking with Sarah, the trainer. Tate's a tough guy. Wouldn't surprise me to see him try and come back out here, but for not only his sake, but for the Mammoth, a guy who's been playing absolutely phenomenally, probably shouldn't come back out because he's been targeted a couple times tonight.
He definitely shouldn't come back out for that reason, and I don't think he'll be physically able to, even if he wants to. But once again, the last thing you want to see, we talked about it, you know, about players getting injured late in the game, games that got out of hand a little bit. And it's just something that you really hate to see.
We talked about it a little earlier today. Michael Marchand recently picked up from the Binghamton Black Bears by the Danbury Hattricks. And earlier this season laid a hit on Noah Wild right in front of the first transit sign across the ice. And that broke Noah Wild's wrist in three places. He's out for the next 4 to 6 weeks for this Mammoth team. And then he lays another hit on Tate Leeson in almost the exact same spot of the ice. And it comes back again. You talk about being a physical player, and that's a huge part of hockey, but things like that should not be a part of hockey.
Absolutely not. Once again, if you want to lay a hit on somebody, a clean open ice hit, or if you want to drop the mitts with somebody and fight, that's part of the game. Hockey's a physical contact sport. It always has been, and it always should be. at the same time, those type of revengeful, spiteful, whatever you want to call it, reactions as Jared Yao is now getting tossed out of the game.
Jared Yao now being sent to the locker room early with 10:28 to play. And let's look ahead for both these teams. We still have a delay here as Stavrosoy has broke a stick in the process, needs to tape a new one up. But as we mentioned, Carolina taking on Danbury tomorrow. That game is going to be in the Danbury Ice Arena tomorrow at 7 p.m. And here for the Mammoth, they will be headed to Watertown to play the Watertown Wolves, a team that they lost to already twice this year. But one was in overtime. It was a very winnable game. And with the way this team's playing already this season, that's a game that it's anyone's.
Absolutely. And the way that the game has gone tonight, we talked about early in this game putting together three periods, not just playing one good period and then slipping up. And so far, obviously, there's 10 minutes left, which is plenty of time in hockey. But the Mammoth have played 2.5 really solid periods. And I think that's really encouraging going into tomorrow and next week. The team proving to themselves that they can do it.
Let's take a look around the FPHL. We gave you the scores a little while ago, but Binghamton has defeated the Port Huron Prowlers 5-3 that game in Port Huron. The Carolina Thunderbirds and the Watertown Wolves tied up at 4. The Motor City Rockers beating the Delaware Thunder by a score of 6-3. And the Columbus River Dragons up over the Mississippi Seawolves by a score of 3-1. It looks like both teams are going to retake the ice here. On the video board up ahead, it says 2 minutes to Michael Marchand, 2 minutes to number 3, Dmitry Daniluk. And we know Jared Yao has been thrown out of the game. So in theory, Mike, this should be a Mammoth power play.
It should be. I'm not exactly sure why Jared Yao got thrown out and not Marchand. I'm not really understanding that one. But either way, you definitely want to see the officials get control of this game so that more things like that don't happen to players.
So Gullo heads back to the ice. And after all that, it looks like it's going to be 4-on-4 hockey here at First Arena. Puck is dropped, and that one won by the Mammoth. Off the backboards for Campbell. Campbell goes up for Becker. Just too far from him off the sideboards. Played back in the defensive end for Xavier Abdel. Abdel goes for Gonzalez. Gonzalez now for Lugo. Lugo into the offensive zone. 10:05 remaining here in the game. Lugo for Gonzalez. He takes a shot on Pradlock. Makes the save. More pushing and shoving between these two teams right out in front of the net at 10:01.
39th save of the game for Thomas Pradlock tonight. He has just been absolutely spectacular. Once again, that shot from the outside. Elmire doing a good job of fronting and keeping the traffic to the outside so Pradlock can see those pucks and hold on to them.
Brennan Sheehan now going to be on the draw. Mammoth shuffling through some changes as they cowboy up over their bench. Levac heads back. Anderson wins the draw. Pekarski tried to play it through and Gibbs tried to get fancy with it, go between his legs, but hit himself. It's dumped into the corner. Parker Butler leaves it for John McDonald. Under 10 to play here now in the third period. Elmira leads this one 4-1 over the Danbury Hattricks. Liriakos goes back for O'Connor. O'Connor through the neutral zone plays it in. That one's caught out of the air by Butler. He'll just hold on to it for a Mammoth offensive zone faceoff.
Got to tell you, Tim O'Connor is a guy that I would not want to get hit by, Jacob.
No, I am agreeing with you. As we take a moment here to thank our hometown heroes inside First Arena. So 9:29 to play here in the third period. 1:01 on the clock for the Marshachan. And Dimitri Danilek penalty. And look who outskates from the locker room. It's Tate Lees, and I think he might be just grabbing some gear.
Yeah, I think he's just grabbing some gear, but oh my God, is that good to see him up and moving. Seems to have a smile on his face, seems to be okay.
I actually think he's just, I really don't think he's going to come back in this game, but I think he wants to be on the bench for this team.
Of course he does. I think that's exactly why he came back out here. He wants to be a part of what's shaping up to be a good result for Elmira.
Golo into the offensive zone, leaves it back for Moscow. Moscow walks in on the backhand. We're going to get a penalty coming up here. It's going to be against the Hatricks. As we're going to get a whistle now. It's going to go to Brendan Sheehan. He'll head to the box and take a look at our upcoming games. Obviously, tomorrow night, the Mammoth will be in Watertown against the Watertown Wolves. But the following weekend, two home games here at First Arena as the Mississippi Seawolves work their way up from the south here into the cold north country of New York State. And they'll take on the Elmira Mammoth at 7:30 Friday night, 6:30 Saturday night. That one should be a good one. These two teams only face each other those two times all season long. Brings a 5-on-3 now for the Mammoth. Liriakos off the draw. Goes for Campbell. Campbell now finds Moscow. Moscow goes back for Campbell at the point. Campbell walks in. He takes a shot that one. Wide of Butler. Liriakos shields his body away. Able to get it through. Campbell shoots that one. Blocked. And there's a souvenir for a fan.
Getting a bit of a different look here, 4-on-4 unit of Liriakos, Gullo, Moscow, and Campbell. Position where Leeson would probably be out here if he was healthy, but obviously he's going to take the rest of the night off.
It'll be a 4-on-3 for the next 26 seconds, I believe. Now Campbell for Moscow. Moscow cross ice for Liriakos. That one through his legs. He can't handle the hot pass. Now the other way goes Lugo. Moscow back checking, able to get on Gonzalez. Lugo stops into the slot, walks by. Cross ice looked for a pass. Proudlock able to poke his stick through. Now to the point. Shot by Gibbs. Easy save there for Proudlock. Whistle blown. It'll be a draw.
Great back check there by Moskal to disrupt that pass. And also a great little poke check there by Proudlock to come out and be aggressive. One thing I like about the way Proudlock plays is he's not afraid to get out of his net. He's not afraid to come out and play the puck. He's not afraid to come out and poke pucks away. It really helps out your defense.
Face-off won by the Mammoth. But the clock never started.
Would you believe that?
So we'll do it all again. Conversation with Mo Levac over in the corner. Parker Moskal picks it up behind the cage. Now Danilek and Michael Marchand come out of the box. 5-on-4 now for the Mammoth for the next minute and 9 seconds. Levac, nifty move by Gibbs. Absorbs a Luke Richards hit. Comes out for Danilek. Danilek behind the cage. Now he goes to the far side. Sends it to the point for Moscow. Moscow down low for Danilek. Danilek looks for Levac. Levac now for Moscow. Moscow shoots that one. Saved by Butler. He'll cover it up between his pads and get a faceoff.
Butler not having too many shots to face in this third period, but he's actually played a very well game nonetheless. If you just look at the stats, 4 goals, 27 shots, probably not statistically the night he was hoping for, but the goals that have gone in really have not been his fault. He's done a good job of keeping Danbury in this game.
That draw won by Zachary Pamillion. He's able to clear it all the way down. 40 seconds remaining on the power play for Elmira. 7:50 here in the third period. Campbell for Moskal. Moskal cross for Liriakos. Liriakos in the offensive zone. Liriakos shoots that one up and over. It's kept in, though, by Moskal. Levac plays it down with a high stick, and he'll get a whistle for that.
Yanni just trying to rip that one in. Missed the net by a little bit. 7:36 left to go. 4-1 Elmira.
That'll bring the faceoff into the neutral zone. And in front of the press box here at First Arena. Gullo and Pamilian going to take the draw. Gullo plays back for Moskal. Moskal for Lyriakos. Lyriakos dumps it in. To the far side, McDonald, the first one to it, clears it all the way down. Crowdlock leaves it back for Nathan Campbell, who goes up for Lyriakos. 5 seconds till Sheehan's out of the box. Goes between the legs for Colo. Colo. Cross ice for Levac. Sheehan comes out of the box. Back to 5-on-5 hockey. Moskal for Gullo. Gullo, Levac. Levac looked to wind up. Thinks better of it. Goes all the way down. It's picked up. Thrown to Parker Moskal. He takes a pass right for Lyriakos, who was sitting on the back door. His shot was sent wide. Now Lyriakos looked to play it for the corner. Gullo goes down. Able to keep it in the offensive zone. Now it does come out. It's Kuznetsov the other way. 3-on-1 for the hat-tricks. Kuznetsov, he takes a shot and a goal. Right by Thomas Proudlock between the legs. It's 4-2 here.
Dmitry Kuznetsov is one of the best shooters in the FPHL. We talked about him in the pregame. Just a bit of a bad bounce off of the rush here. Leads to a 3-on-1 chance for the hat-tricks. Kuznetsov decides to shoot the puck, and it pays a dividend for him. 4-2 Elmira.
Kuznetsov had 2 goals last night against Binghamton, had a couple the last time these two teams played, and he's able to net the second of the game. Mammoth in the defensive end, it's Dakota Seaman. Tries to pass it in, it goes behind Parker Butler. Kuznetsov, 7th goal of the season for the Danbury Hat-Tricks, has his 10th point, reaches double digits in the points column for Danbury. Michael Marchessault chips it in. Pekarski works by a slide in Dustin Giselle. He stopped in the neutral zone. Evan Lugo picks that one up. Gonzalez plays it all the way down. Giselle avoids a hit from Pekarski, spins away and dumps it into the corner for Lugo. Seaman the first one to it. Looked to play it for Wolf, just too far from him. Hat-tricks re-entered the zone. 5:45 to play here in the third period. 2-goal lead here for the Elmira Mammoth. Wolf, the first one to it. Plays it into the corner. Now he'll work his way up. Jakub Wolf through the neutral zone. He'll cross the red line and just play it in. Isaiah Crawford skates on. Battle in the corner with Cody Gibbs. Gibbs wins that one, hands it off for Luke Richards. Richard tries to get it through, that one blocked and dumped right back in by the Mammoth. Gibbs, pass up for Mike Lopez, left off for Richards, and he'll just play it in.
Great aggressive forecheck here by Elmira, not allowing Danbury to even get the puck out of their own zone.
Isaiah Crawford takes a hit through the neutral zone, under 5 minutes to play here in the third period.
One thing you cannot do if you're Elmira here is take a stupid penalty. You cannot give Danbury that power play opportunity.
Moskal shields away from a hit as it's played into the far side corner. Abdella passing to the neutral zone. Now finds a streaking Michael Marchessault. He works by Maritea. Right out in front and a goal! Michael Marchessault and the Danbury hat-tricks answer right back, and it's now 4-3.
What a goal that was by Marchessault. Went around Dmitry Daniluk, got in, and went between the legs and upstairs over Thomas Proudlock. That is an ESPN top 10 play right there. Something you don't see very often, Jacob.
Michael Marchessault scores his first goal of the season as a member of the Danbury Hat-Tricks. Comes for Campbell. Campbell dumps it in. Parker Butler plays it off his stick. 4:20 to play here. Mammoth with a 1-goal lead over the Danbury Hat-Tricks. A game that they have controlled for about 50 minutes of this one. Seaman tries to catch it out of the air. Marchessault takes a shot. That one off the top of the stick of Proudlock and up and into the netting.
Hey fans, please turn your attention to the video board.
Obviously, two big goals there for Danbury. That one came off of a very big individual effort by Michael Marchesham. But, man, if you're Elmira right now, you really, really have to tighten up on the defensive end. Some of the best chances for Danbury is coming in these final 10 minutes, which really is not a recipe for success.
So with just 4:07 to play here, I imagine, Mike, if this game stays 4-3 for the next 2 minutes, at what time, ideally, you know, everyone says it different, what time do you pull Parker Butler?
It obviously depends on the coach's preference and what he has grown up on his end. If I'm in this position and I'm up by a goal, I would probably give it to about the minute and a half mark. A thing coaches will also use to judge when they're going to pull the goalie is how their offensive pressure is. If they're getting good offensive pressure 5-on-5, they'll wait a little bit longer to take that chance.
Levac wins the draw, plays it back for Campbell, who goes up for Lyriakos. Lyriakos jumps away from a hit, but Lopez puts it on his stick. Campbell over for Becker, under 4 to play here. Saucer pass up for Lyriakos, who finds Levac. Levac leaves it off for Colo. Colo takes a shot, that one saved by Butler. Twig goes flying. Becker keeps it at the point. He drops it down low to the far side. Colo takes a shot on that one. Covered up by Butler. He lays on it and just keeps it from crossing the line.
Butler with two shaky saves there. Obviously, the second one he kind of had to lean back on. Looked like they handcuffed him a bit. Big final 3.5 minutes here.
3:40 to play. Jakub Wolf going to take the draw. Murray wins that, plays a neutral zone for Kuznetsov. Michael Marchesham coming the other way. At the last goal, he takes a shot that's played all the way wide. Wolf on that, comes from Marchesham. He's in the high slot. Pass across Kuznetsov. Closing the pad was Proudlock. Marchesham with the rebound on in front, and it's 4-4. The Elmira Mammoth blown a 4-1 lead in the last 6 minutes of the period. It's now knotted all the way up, back at 4.
Just good sustained pressure there by Danbury. They got the puck to the net. Proudlock had to make a big pad save sliding to the right post from his left. And then once again, Michael Marchesham just in the right spot, right in front of the net, picks up the loose change. And if you're Elmira right now, you need to do something because everything is going wrong. Maybe take a timeout, maybe do something, but you can't continue this.
Chameleon unable to get to that. Anderson and Danilek just played into the corner. 3:15 to play here. Kuznetsov receives the assist on the Michael Marchesham goal, his second of the game. Now it's chipped into the offensive zone. Christopher Maritea skates on. Skates behind Proudlock. Pass up for Crawford. Crawford goes up for Wolf. Wolf just plays it into the corner. Wraps around the boards, works behind the cage. It's Crawford and Gonzalez. He leaves it off for Pamillion. Wolf there as well. Skating the other way is Connor Lind. Lind with a pass for Sheehan. Sheehan just dumps it in. Danbury going to get a change. Five new guys coming out from their bench. 4-4 game. Hello. Cross-ice pass looking for Lyriakos. Sliding in the net was Marchesham.
Marchesham just lost his footing there. That faceoff will stay inside. Both top lines out there for each team. You got the Gesso line for Danbury and then the Levesque line for Elmira.
2.5 to play here between the Mammoth and the Hattricks.
Face-offs have never been more important than they are right now. 2.5 minutes left. Possession and winning the face-off is very important.
Back wins the draw, shot immediately by Lyriakos off the backside of Gulo, and that's going to head right up into the netting. There was a set play there from Levac and Lyriakos. Looked to get a quick rip off the face-off. Levac wins it again. Lyriakos keeps it in front of him, plays it down into the corner. Picked up by Gibbs back by the net. Now Lyriakos finds it. Lyriakos tried a centering pass. That went off the end of the stick of Parker Butler. Picked up by the Hatricks. It's Abdullah coming the other way. Abdullah working in the offensive zone. He takes a shot. That one sent wide. Another shot on that one off the side of the post and back behind the cage. Under 2 minutes to play here. It's up for Campbell. Campbell able to clear the zone. Lugo tried to pass. It's picked up by Nathan Campbell. Campbell into the offensive zone. Campbell tries to drag by. He will into the corner. Centering pass. That one saved by Butler. Still loose out in front. Lyriakos holds it off. Slap shot coming from O'Connor. That one wide.
Great play there by Tim O'Connor to step up. The puck just skipped over his stick as he went to take the slap shot.
Proudlock raises his hand. It'll be an icing. Both groups.
If
very
I'm
tired legs on that one.
Yeah, if I'm Coach Billy McCreary here, I definitely burn a timeout. It looks like he's going to. He's grabbing the whiteboard. Yeah, he's taking it. Smart move by Coach Billy McCreary, giving your guys a rest. Setting up some sort of defensive structure off the faceoff here. 1:27 left to go.
Well, 4-4 game here. First arena, Danbury takes their timeout after that icing call. Give that group a rest as both groups for both teams have been out there for a while. Coach Glenn Tamaris talking to his crew on the bench to draw something up here with just a minute 27. And Mike, overtime here. It's a game where you were up 4-1. You thought you had 3 points in the bag, but against this Danbury Hatricks team, obviously the mood changes, but to even come out of this game with a point is huge, but not what you want.
Obviously not. Game's far from over. Obviously it's a 4-4 game. But at the same time, if you're Elmira right now, you have to remember you dominated this game for two periods. So although almost 2.5 periods. So past 5 or 6 minutes haven't been good, but Elmira can definitely figure a way to pull this one out.
Anderson on the draw with Lugo. That one won by Anderson. Moskal takes a shot. That one blocked away by Parker Butler. It's the neutral zone for Jussault. Now a pass up for Soyas. That one goes under his stick. He'll get a change. Goes off the glass, up and over the head of O'Connor. Pekarski has to skate back to get it. Lopez on his back. Pekarski goes down into the corner. Lyriakos makes a move by Lopez and Sheehan. Up for Moskal. Moskal finds Lyriakos. Lyriakos shielded off. He's held it to the glass. Loses his stick now. He goes down into the corner. Under a minute to play here in regulation. Saucer pass. That one played all the way down. O'Connor going to touch up. That'll be icing.
Not a good icing there to take if you're Danbury. And Jacob, I will point out, Tate Leeson obviously has not returned to the ice. Probably will not for the remainder of this game. At the 10-minute mark, around when that happened, that wasn't that big of a deal. If you're Elmira, you're up 4-1. Now, 49 seconds left, a game that could potentially go into 3-on-3 overtime and a shootout. Not having Tate Leeson is a big, big blow.
It looks like maybe we'll get a timeout here. Another one used. Proudlock skates over to his bench. And it's going to be an Elmira Mammoth timeout. Head coach Glenn Tamaris trying to draw something up here off the faceoff. The game that the Mammoth basically won about 50 minutes of this one. The Hatricks have stormed back here at the first arena and made it a 4-4 game. Both teams start working their way back onto the ice. The group that's going to be out there for Elmira, Yanni Lyriakos, Parker Moskal, Dmitry Danilek, Mo Levac, and Nick Gulo. Interesting to note there is there's only one defender on the ice in Dmitry Danilek, the rest forwards.
Coach Tamaris being aggressive here and going with an offensive attack unit.
That draw won by the Hatricks. Connor Lynn picks it up, plays it to the near side. Now the puck works through the neutral zone and Dmitry Danilek plays it in. Lind picks it up, now waits behind the cage. 35 seconds to play here. Levac has that one held up in his skates as it goes down for Lopez. Lopez into the offensive zone, guarded by Moskal. It's played back behind the cage. Brendan Sheehan, the first one to it. Now a centering pass that Proudlich plays off a stick to Lyriakos. 18 seconds left. Lyriakos just flips it all the way up into the air. And I believe that one hit the video board.
It did. I hope it didn't break it. I mean, that's a really unfortunate play because now the faceoff is going to stay in the zone for Elmira. I will note, and you know, this is just me being a former goaltender. Former goaltender, I don't know. I retired 2 weeks ago. But Thomas Proudlich loves to play the puck and avoid those face-offs. A lot of goalies would have covered the puck in that situation, but he moved it, which is a smart play because you do not want to give Danbury the offensive face-off that they're unfortunately getting now.
Lugo and Levac going to be on the draw. So offensive face-off for the Hattricks here with 14 seconds left. Going to be won by the Mammoth and played all the way down. Anderson looks to skate on it. Icing will be called. It looked like they were going to wave it off quickly, but 7 seconds left. Danbury going to have time. They win the faceoff to set something up with just 7 seconds remaining.
Parker Moskal just tried to float that one out. It was just a touch too hard of a saucer pass.
A clear here basically sends it overtime, Mike. And that one going to be cleared by Moskal, caught out of the air by Gibbs. Shot by Jussieu, played into the corner. And, Mike, we're going to have free hockey here at First Arena tonight. 4-4 game between the Danbury Hattricks and the Elmira Mammoth. Going to be a 3-on-3 overtime period. And if nothing settled in that time, it'll be a shootout for the important 2 points here against the Hattricks.
Obviously, the way the season started out for the Mammoth, not winning many games, you have to be, you know, it's a step in the right direction to get a point. But, I mean, this is a game that the Mammoth, the Mammoth definitely wanted to win in regulation. Opportunity here to fight back and to get a win. A win in overtime counts as the same as a win in regulation, not the same as a loss, unfortunately.
Both teams, regardless of outcome, will at least receive 1 point as we're headed to overtime here. If you look at the scores around the FPHL, I have a break here. Watertown with a 5-4 lead over the Carolina Thunderbirds. Columbus River Dragons up 4-1 over the Mississippi Seawolves. Motor City Rockers up 6-3 over the Delaware Thunder. And the Black Bears completed the victory over the Port Huron Prowlers by a score of 5-3. Under 2 minutes until overtime starts here. Mike, first overtime that we've seen here at First Arena this year, second of the season, obviously against the Watertown Wolves earlier this year that they fell 6-5 in. But what are your approaches here in an overtime period, not only as a goalie, but you know, as a team? How do you approach this?
Well, one of the biggest things about 3-on-3 hockey is how much space there is. So one thing you do not want to do is you do not want to dump the puck into the other team's end. You want to try and keep possession for as long as you can, because keeping that possession is what allows you to get the chances. There's enough space where you don't have to dump the puck. It's not crowded ice. Possession is definitely the name of the game in 3-on-3.
Two different approaches here. The Mammoths sending out just Parker Moskal and their defenders, Christopher Maritea and Nathan Campbell. The Hattricks with two forwards and just one defender as Maritea skates in the offensive zone. He plays it back for Campbell. Campbell goes off the sideboards for Moskal. Moskal takes a shot, that one blocked and sent up into the net. It'll be an offensive zone draw for Elmira.
It's a good point, Jacob. Two different coaching styles here, coaching methods, whatever you want to call it. Danbury going with two forwards, and then Elmira going with two defensemen. Obviously two defensemen in Maritea and Campbell that can produce offensively.
Moskal on the draw in the near side. That one still battled on the skates, now comes out for Dustin Jussieu. Jussieu waits behind the cage of Parker Butler. Still waiting back in the defensive end as Gonzalez works forward. Pass through the neutral zone for Evan Lugo. Lugo goes back in the defensive end for Jussieu. He skates back. 4:20 to play here in overtime. Jussieu into the offensive zone.
Hard hit there in the neutral zone. Jusso tries to make a move by Maritea. He'll keep it on his stick, come to the point. And he'll just skate out into the neutral zone. A couple changes coming. Tim O'Connor comes on for the Mammoth. Two new Danbury hat tricks off their bench. Jusso into the corner. Goes all the way down. Moscow now going to come off the ice as well as Nathan Campbell.
Smart play by Dustin Jusso there. Veteran forward in this league. Sends the puck back into his end and does not give up possession for his team.
Now Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov with no help as he comes in the offensive zone. He takes a shot. That one blocked by Pekarski. Still in the offensive zone. Now Kuznetsov comes out in the neutral zone with it. Danbury with most of the possession here in the first minute and 20 seconds of overtime. Kuznetsov goes off Sheehan into the offensive zone. Takes a shot. Proudlock makes the glove save. Proudlock drops the puck. Now wraps it back around. Tim O'Connor, the first one to get to it. Sheehan with tire legs as Tim O'Connor wakes behind the cage. 3:20 to play here. O'Connor goes up for Gulo. Nick Gulo. Gulo into the offensive zone. Now he skates back into the neutral zone. Pass for Yanni Liriakos, tape to tape. Pekarski comes off. Liriakos shuffles one across for Nathan Campbell. Campbell into the offensive zone. Campbell has space. He's shielding his body away. He's tripped. No call. Nathan Campbell sent out in front. Liriakos tried to get a backhand shot. That one sent wide.
Too many men on the ice for Elmira. Oh, boy. How does that happen, man?
How do you miss a tripping call right out in front of the net? So Parker Moscow going to head to the box for too many men on the ice at 2:47 here in overtime.
Borderline missed call down at the end. Campbell went to the net. It was a hard play. 3-on-3 overtime. You're typically not going to get that many calls. But somehow Elmira ended up with four players on the ice. And this brings us to a very important Vincenzo's Pizza penalty kill.
2:47 to play here as Zavac plays that draw to the blue line. It's kept in by Gonzalez. Kuznetsov throws it across for Evan Lugo. Lugo back for Gonzalez. Gonzalez drops it down low to the near side for Evan Lugo. Lugo out for Gonzalez, now over for Jusso. Jusso sends it through looking for Dmitry Kuznetsov. It's played all the way. Lugo for Gonzalez. Gonzalez quarterbacking the power play here for the Hattricks, guarded there by Levac. Levac holds it along the corner. Levac still has it. He's able to get it all the way clear. 1:20 remaining here on the Parker Moscow. Too many men on the ice penalty. 2:05 in the overtime period.
What a play there by Mo Levac to clear that puck. Two guys on him. He still gets it out.
Jusso shoots, and Pekarski gets his stick on it and sends it up into the netting. 1:58 remaining in the overtime.
Second unit coming out here for Danbury. Michael Marchessault has two in this one already. He'll be the net front guy here looking for his third.
Dalton Anderson and Christopher Maritea. Penalty kill unit here as Anderson wins the draw. Maritea wraps it all the way around. Nobody covering the far side in front of the Mammoth bench. And that'll be played down. 1 minute remaining here on the power play for the Hattricks. Minute 45 in the overtime. It's Sheehan. Sheehan into the offensive zone. Hands off for Marchessault. Marchessault dumps it into the near side corner. He's held up there by Danila. Comes out. Now for Mikey Lopez. Lopez switches place with McDonald. McDonald at the blue line. 40 seconds remaining on the power play. McDonald now for Sheehan. For Lopez. Lopez walks in, shoots, and they score. With a minute 17 remaining in overtime, Mikey Lopez ends it. And the Hattricks come away with the victory.
Good shot there by Mikey Lopez. Way too much time walking in from the side angle. Beats Thomas Proudlock, who, tip our hat to him, played a fantastic game. Despite the late breakdown from Elmira, definitely not his fault at all. Unfortunate loss here for the Mammoth.
It's going to be a power play goal for the Hattricks. And then we're going to head back to Danbury, Connecticut tonight. A happy group with a 5-4 victory over the Elmira Mammoth. The Elmira Mammoth get 1 point on the night. That'll, depending on the result of the Delaware Thunder game, as they're trailing 6-3. The Mammoth, well, 5 points on the season. A game that, Mike, they very much should have won. They were ahead by 3 goals with about 6 minutes to play, and a collapse from the Elmira Mammoth at First Arena.
Excuse me, definitely a collapse. Something that you really hate to see. This group really had a good first 2.5 periods, and then just some bad defensive lapses in the final 10 minutes. A really unfortunate too many men on the ice penalty in overtime, and that was the dagger in this one.
Well, that's going to do it here from First Arena tonight in Elmira, New York. The Elmira Mammoth fall to the Danbury Hatricks by a score of 5-4. They'll be back in action tomorrow night in Watertown, that game at 7:30. That game available on the Elmira Mammoth Mixler. We hope you tune in for that one tomorrow night. For Jake Johnson and Michael Cosentino, we hope you have a great rest of your night. Thanks for tuning in.